All right, we're back, and we're back with all the regulars and Lewis.
Welcome back, Kelly. We're happy to have you.
Hey, it's nice to be here.
Guys, you look so great. You've lost so much weight.
Yeah, I missed you, Lou. Lulu.
I miss you too, Kel.
How's James?
He's doing so good. I heard you wrote a new hour of material.
I did. It's all about how it's called Up and Down, the story of my weight.
Kelly, how did you lose all the weight, Kelly?
I ripped my asshole open again.
Oh, wow.
It just fell out of her in one sitting.
It's me.
It's been the whole time.
You know, can I just say something about Kelly Festuca, you know, who, you know, for 3 years was on the show, 2.5 years, whatever it was.
Yeah.
She hasn't contacted me once.
No.
Not one email, not one text message. Not a Facebook, not a Twitter.
Oh, my God. I hope she's dead.
No, she's not dead. I follow her on Instagram.
I talked to her like 2 weeks after, and then that was it after.
She hasn't even, not even a happy Thanksgiving. How's Max?
Who's Max?
The baby that likes me better than you.
He likes me 0%. I sound tinny again.
Which means, I like you 0%.
Oh, that's unsensitive.
So it's the same.
By the way, Bobby, you're...
That's unsensitive?
My thing sounds crazy again. Does it sound normal to you guys?
No, you sound a little fucking weird, man.
Yeah.
I hope it's not this fucking thing.
Probably Deepu? Don't call him a thing.
Yes.
He's a human being.
He's racist. I mean, sure, he has one eyebrow, but I get it.
Oh, dude.
Of course you do, because you have one too.
He's literally the sexiest Indian person ever.
It sounds weird again.
Yeah. It sounds weird.
I don't know.
Sounds like we're back on the 1920s radio. It's the Bobby Kelly Radio Hour.
UFOs were seen over the skyline.
Want to talk about Joe DiMaggio being spotted out on the town with Marilyn Monroe?
When Lewis thinks 1920s, he thinks UFOs.
Yeah, because he's a...
That was a big UFO period in America.
1920s, I don't even think they talked UFOs back then.
No, that was more like 50s.
Well, don't you remember the fucking...
No, we don't.
The War of the Worlds or whatever it was when they played.
That
and
wasn't
people
the 20s, that was the 1920s, you kook.
50s, you fucking...
It wasn't even the 50s. It was during the Great Depression, which was the 1930s.
No. All right, well, it wasn't the 20s.
For you, it was closer to the 20s.
For your family,
than it
was the 80s.
Lewis thinks The Great Gatsby is about a UFO. Admit it.
Wow.
Bobby, can I pick a bone?
Yeah, you can pick a bone. Can you pick up the fucking bomb bandana while you're at it, too?
Yeah, that was a tough one.
Jesus Christ, where is it?
Yeah, that Great Gatsby one, we saw that.
Yeah, the Great Gatsby. You probably think the Great Gatsby.
Oh,
ugh.
I don't even.
Just take
Before
it.
Before you pick your bone real quick, Bobby, your theme song is on WWE 2K15 for PlayStation 4.
Yeah, they steal everything of mine.
I know.
Do you play as King Kong Bundy and pretend it's Bobby?
Yeah.
That's good.
A lot of characters stole your weight.
It's good.
Wow, I'm glad it's there. I'm glad you draped it over there, too.
I think it's the reverb is hurting my punchlines.
I don't know what to tell you. I mean, it is a little reverby, but...
That's not reverb. Neither of you guys know what the fuck you're talking about. It's static, dude.
From what? What do you want me to do?
Wayne Static. He died. He's here in the spirit now.
Well, who fucking did? I mean, it works fine, and then it doesn't. What do you want me to do?
Yeah, we're just going to...
Well, is it
through.
Recording that way? As long as it's not recording that
you
way,
you
want me
to stop and find out?
Kind of, yeah.
Dude.
Listen to me. If we go through a whole show, and it's like this... You're literally going to kill Deepu.
Then kill me.
And then kill Scopo with Deepu's bones.
Scopo looks great.
All right, I'm going to stop it for 1 second.
All right.
We're still on video, though.
Hey,
so
what's
keep
up?
Keep doing stuff. Here we
dude.
Go. Wait, wait. I mean, it is a little reverby, but...
That's not reverb. Neither of you guys know what the fuck you're talking about. It's
what
like static,
it?
Dude.
From what? What do you want me to do?
Wayne Static. He died. He's here in the spirit now.
Well, who fucking did? I mean, it works fine, and then it doesn't. What do you want me to do?
Yeah, we're just gonna
well, is it recording that way? As long as it's not recording that
you
way, it doesn't matter.
You want to stop and find out?
Kind of, yeah.
Dude.
Listen to me. If we go through a whole show and it's like this, you're literally going to kill Deepu.
I feel like you know what it is.
Then, yeah.
Then kill me.
Then kill Scopo with Deepu's bones.
Scopo looks great.
High, I feel, I'm going to stop it for 1 second.
I think,
yeah, where is the gain? The
I don't
gain,
know.
I'm controlling the gain right here.
I feel like the gain is too high because if you're back away from it, don't eat your mic too much.
Okay, there we go. All right, we're back. We're not going to eat our mics. Right?
I think that sounds better, right?
I think so.
I think it sounds much better.
Yeah.
I'd like a little more juice in my mic.
Okay, you want some? Where are you?
Can I get some juice in mine, too?
Go ahead.
I'll take some juice.
I just love some orange juice.
That right there feels real good.
Okay, so stay back. How's that? Is that good?
Do I got anything? No.
It wasn't a joke. I want orange juice, you fucking cunt.
It's because you're diabetic, you fat fuck.
Stop screaming. That's what you're blowing.
Diabetic.
You're blowing out all the mics.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
The only thing
you just
know about...
told us not to eat the mics, and you're literally eating the mic. Can you shave? Can you shave, dude?
Is the only thing you know about diabetes from the movie Steel Magnolias?
I've never seen Steel Magnolias, so why don't you back
drink
off,
the orange juice?
Yeah, I'm all crazy over here.
This is bananas.
Yeah, whatever.
I honestly don't think I've ever sound better on this podcast.
You sound great. I sound great. That's all that matters. Yeah. Fucking corporate Dan and fucking the dude.
Yeah.
Sounds great.
Ooh.
Listen.
Oh, maybe I should try this microphone that's not on.
Actually, no, that sounded really good, dude.
Go ahead.
Hey, what about this microphone?
Oh, that sounds great.
Ooh, that's nice.
That sounds great. I say go over there. Right there. I say Lewis leaves.
Get the Kelly spot.
Why would you say that, Dan?
I don't know, because your little chin wisp is upsetting me.
It's literally disgusting.
When's the last time I got the call for YKWD? I literally got it yesterday. I had a shame.
2 weeks ago when you hosted the show.
You literally, not only were you on the show, you were the show.
And I got a bone to pick with Joe.
All right, wait a minute. Who do you have a bone to pick?
I have a bone to pick with Dan.
All right, you got a bone to pick. What's your bone to pick?
I just want to watch dudes pick on other dudes' bones.
And you got a bone to pick with Joe?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
What's my bone? I want
to
hit my bone.
I texted you twice to do the show last week, and not even a response.
Ooh.
Well, I don't remember that. I think I got
show
it.
You the text messages.
Maybe your phone's fucked up with texting, Joe.
I think it is,
because you texted me, and I didn't get that text.
I texted Lewis. I wrote, I love you, I miss you, and your son.
Bobby, look, on Wednesday, November 26th.
Don't eat the mic. Remember, we're not eating the mic today.
Hey, Joe, can you do
the
podcast Monday at 9? No response. Then Saturday, hey, Joe, can you do the podcast Monday at 9? No response.
You know what it was? I was working, I was on the road, and I was gay. And,
you're
gay? Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah,
it's no big deal.
That's completely
Monday at 9,
what?
Kelly's hair. This mic stinks. I apologize. But anyways, I wrote to Lewis, I love you, I miss your baby, I hate Bobby's baby, and why don't we hang out? And then he never wrote back.
Why do you hate my son?
I have no clue.
He's cocky, dude.
What do you mean my kid's
your
cocky?
Your kid's cocky.
Wait,
he
hold
should
on.
Be cocky.
Dude.
He has a better life than your kid.
He's gorgeous.
He has one house.
They
he stays
don't even
in.
Know what lives are like that. Yeah.
He has one mailman. He has one UPS guy. He knows his neighbors.
And he's the one mailman is his dad.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Where's the bandana?
It's on fucking Lewis's dumb orange juice microphone.
Which, by the way, great Steel Magnolias follow-up.
Okay, so what's your bone to pick?
I just, my bone is, it's kind of almost deep.
Covered in warts.
And herpes. I sent Lewis a sweet text about I wanted to hang out with him and his baby, and I said, I miss you and I love you, and I never heard back.
And I told you I didn't get it. I showed you on my phone that I didn't get it.
That's because you got a dumb Puerto Rican phone that doesn't work.
It's Metro PCS.
Oh, wow. You got a burner?
It's not a burner, dude. It's prepaid. There's no contract.
He's in the Sons of Anarchy with that phone.
I got a burner, but we already talked about it. It's on my dick.
So what's your bone to pick with Lewis?
It's over. I already
said it three times, Bobby.
Yeah, that's it.
I have a bone to pick with you. You don't listen.
Hang on 1 second. We'll get to your bone. So you're mad at him, but you send these. Can I say something to you about your I love you messages?
Yeah, please.
I think they're fucking disingenuous.
What are you talking about?
I don't think you fucking mean them.
Nobody knows if it's a real word, but we're all going to give it to you.
Thank you. I think that
Before you finish, you're hurting me right now.
See, I think this is a lie, too.
Got your herpes again.
Yeah. Are you saying that Joe's texts kind of feel like when a stripper says you're cute?
No. What I think, it's more like, I miss you, I love you. And then if you call him, I'll go, hey, I miss you, I love you too. He's like, yeah, whatever. And then he'll fucking smash you.
Joe doesn't answer my calls.
Hold on. Anytime Joe posts anything on Facebook, he can be like, hey, go to the DMV. Love you guys. Bye. He loves everyone. Always. Yeah. So that's why he's saying it's disingenuous or whatever he's saying.
I don't just say I love you to somebody. If I say I love you to you, I really fucking mean it. Like, it's really, I love you,
Joe.
He doesn't
say it to the entire Facebook community.
I love your lips. This is the closest I've ever been to you.
Bobby's got lips like a glazed donut. They're always wet and tasty looking.
Are you writing like monologue jokes?
Yeah. Holy
Bobby's
God.
Got, what are you, a cartoon fucking comic? Should have stuck with the old monologue.
You were right there. I was about to jump in on the monologue thing.
His delivery stinks.
He's like, Bobby's here. Bobby Kelly's here. Bobby's got the lips like a glazed donut.
Always wet, and you want to eat them.
We got a great show for you. The Foo Fighters are here tonight.
Eyes like charcoal, he does.
Listen,
are the Foo Fighters really here?
No, they're not.
I'd go ape shit.
I think I send statutory ape shit.
I'm going to see them at fucking Fenway Park.
Me too, buddy.
Yeah, well, you're backstage? VIP?
You're not going VIP.
I do. I got VIP, motherfucker.
Oh, are you sure you're not VJP?
What's that?
very jerk person.
Listen.
That was going to be a fat joke, and I fucking called an audible.
At the line?
Yeah. What was going to be the fat joke?
What I'm saying, Joe.
VFP.
Dan, back me up on this.
Yeah,
he
bro.
Says, I love you. And then you call him up and be like, hey, man, I love you, too. And he gets weird about that.
No.
Stiff arms you.
You do a thing, and you know you do it. And I've talked to other close friends of yours. And then when I bring it up, they just start laughing because they're like, ah, it's funny that you guys know what a fucking jerk-off Bobby is. You play into people's personality. You know that I'm a fucking nervous Nelly, yeah. And I'm afraid that everyone's mad at me. And I know that I'm gay, but I don't want to tell people. And then you call.
See that? Are you really gay?
You call.
Is he gay?
I wouldn't treat him differently if he was.
Do you understand? You never know when it's real with him.
He's Sarah's always, a dude.
And wrong. Then you call and you're like this, Joe, it's Bobby, call me. And so now I got to freak out.
Those are terrible. By the way, those are
terrible. Those are the worst.
That's what you do.
Yeah. Listen, you do it to all your friends.
I have a tone issue.
Yeah, you
do. I'm self-admitted with that, okay?
I always, even though I know I did nothing wrong, I feel like I did the
you
worst
think, I feel
thing.
The same
you think
way.
You? How about me?
Well,
yeah.
Oh, it's Scopo, yeah, but you probably did do something.
You probably get
yeah,
it.
But when the message is 20 seconds longer, I know I'm fucked. If it's 5 seconds, I'm like, all right, he just wants
dude,
me to call
anytime
him
anytime I look at my phone and it's Bobby Kelly, I literally walk out of the room for my chick and my child.
I cry.
Because, no. Because I could be getting yelled at, and I don't want my son to see me breaking down.
That's not true.
I don't want him to see in my eyes me being the non-alpha male.
The last couple months we've talked have been very cordial.
I know, and now I feel like I'm off guard, and it's a game of numbers as well. So the next one, any day now, he's going to fucking be, dude, what the fuck did you do to the fucking wire in my studio, you little motherfucker?
What did you do? Was it you who fucked
did
the studio up?
That's why would
weird
I even say that?
You just
ratted on himself.
What did you do?
By the way, it sounds great right now.
What?
I will say it does sound amazing
what
right
did
now.
You do?
I didn't do anything.
Bro,
I spilled the coffee something. Into the mixer.
Did you?
No,
we'll
dude.
Get a new mixer. Hey, I don't no. care. I really don't.
By the way, that is amazing acting. You really do have a show coming out on
Scopo,
FX.
Scopo, do you have sugar up here?
What the fuck? Why are you going to stop the flow for your fucking sugar?
You're sucking your dick about your show. We all know it's going to be good.
Hey, Bobby.
What the fuck? That's not even what he was talking about. First of all. Don't make me into a fucking Benny Hill character. Joe.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but, you know, sometimes I'm real about this, that you say I love you. You say I love you so much, man. You've helped me so much. And I'm like, hey, man, I really appreciate that. And you get weirded out by that. Like you don't get weirded out.
You I
don't
love
reciprocate it.
I love reciprocating. What are you kidding?
Can you somebody I keep all say my it right? One of you guys.
I keep all my receipts.
You both have the opportunity to say the second R.
Reciprocate.
You got to keep your receipts because the taxes they take these things.
Reciprocate.
Reciprocate.
Am I out of line saying that?
You're hurting feelings.
You understand?
I get where you're coming from.
At least,
corporate
at least.
Dan from right in the middle, Dan.
Where?
And I'll tell you, as somebody who constantly looks in my rearview mirrors at the line behind me, I will say, you're in line.
Man, throw that bomb in.
Give me the fucking bandana, faggot.
Yeah. I don't even know what that was.
Stop saying faggot on my show.
You just said faggot.
And you were saying the N-word before.
No, I wasn't.
You
dropped that hard.
Are you fucking kidding me, man?
You said it with like a lot of intention.
Yeah, insane.
I said sand nigger. That's not the same thing.
Dude.
He's right.
Jesus.
Dude, I'm sorry.
It's all right.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
Deepu, I listened to your show that you are on. I do not like that Puerto Rican man who is calling you those words. I put an old Hindi curse on him. His son will be as light as a flower.
This is Deepu's mother, though, right?
Deepu, it's your mom.
Jesus Christ, Lewis. The fuck, bro?
What?
I got like Joe's going the opposite route now. It's
supposed to be dogs.
Deepu, are you okay with that?
The SN word?
Yeah.
that means no.
He is handsome. God damn it, dude.
It's an up and down journey with me. That's all. It's,
for an SN word, yeah, he's really handsome.
You think Deepu's good looking?
He's fucking.
You're insane.
For an Indian guy.
Let me see.
He's literally the best looking Indian guy I've ever seen in my life.
Look at that.
Yeah, but the camera.
Structure.
The camera's fucking cleaning his skin up. It's, yeah. The 5 o'clock shadow looks perfect in the camera.
Deepu
looks
like.
It adds the right 10 pounds to my face.
Deepu looks like if you caught a man turning into a werewolf at just the right time.
Your eyebrow hair and your pubic hair should not connect. That's my theory when it comes to sexy men.
I think Scopo looks really sexy.
I think Scopo.
You really have a thing for like.
He got
you know,
thin.
Do you know how much better looking Deepu is than Scopo?
Not at all.
No,
you guys are just fucking racist. Like,
you know
okay,
what?
Hold on. I say sand nigger and then I'm the racist. I'm joking, okay? You guys genuinely see him like he's an animal, okay?
Scopo's
an ugly,
body.
Bald-nosed, fucking normal white guy. Deepu's very good looking.
Deepu, great face. You Scopo body.
I would rather fuck that ass. You see that ass?
Yeah.
That's going to feel like
now.
A tight pussy
I'm just
when
saying,
you put it in that ass.
What's better looking? Joe. Yeah, Joe
has a hemorrhoid though. So.
Do you?
Yeah.
How do you know?
How do I know? Because every time I take a shit, it kills me for like 3 days.
Wow, you can't fucking do any. You get fucked in the ass then. No. What's up, Joe?
Hey, buddy. first of all, Scopo's back would be a better tone to come on because that white to brown, mm-hmm. it would look kind of sexy, you know.
Wait, Scopo's back would be better to come on?
No, Deepu.
Yes, 100%.
Did I say Scopo? I meant
not
Deepu.
Only, but think about putting your hand, Joe, for you because I fuck a lot of white women. Think about putting your hand on Deepu's back, the tone of your skin versus the tone of his skin. How nice that would be.
Why would you say for me? I fuck white women.
No, I'm just saying for
white
you,
woman.
Because you want...
What is your fucking... All right, listen, we're getting
oh,
started.
Oh, here's
is your...
what I was going to say.
What?
Soder, everyone rewind, because this is a funny moment. Soder was going to make a joke about me being gay, because I was like, Scopo's handsome. He's like, he has a thing, and then Lewis interrupted by being like, Deepu is more attractive than Scopo, and then Soder bailed on his gay joke and was like, no way, Scopo's more attractive. And it was really a fun moment.
I didn't think I was going to make a gay joke.
We were like, look at you, you got a thing for Scopo's way more attractive.
I liked it.
It was fun. You look great.
What's your fucking bone to pick with me?
I said I was a joke because I said you don't listen.
Oh, well, apparently I do.
Because you asked
20 minutes
Joe
later,
List,
and I brought it back.
You asked Joe List 3 times what his bone to pick with me was, and he just kept on saying it over and over again.
So there's no, you have no bone? Did you, you don't have a bone?
No, I love you. You know what? I will say I have a bone. I have a bone.
Throw it out there, buddy.
What's Can I have up, a new bro? Segment on the show called Lewis's Bone?
Not at all.
No. Yeah, go ahead.
Lewis's Bone, this week.
Wait,
this
you need
is the
music
first
time. You need music.
All right, can I get music? Joe, can a little bit of old school.
And trumpet. Joining us now, sponsored by Dial Soap and Barilla Cream, it's another one of Lewis's Bones. With Lewis J. Gomez. He's 3/5 of a person because he's Puerto Rican.
You know, Bob, I'll tell you, this is the first time in a very long time. Okay, excuse me. Hey, Charlie, can you turn the music down a little bit?
The music has to play during the whole
just say,
you need a sound.
I just don't want to do
I'll turn it
loud.
Down. I'll turn it down on the board. Okay, go ahead.
Perfect. Yeah, you turn up a little bit more.
Okay, go ahead. There we go.
So, listen, it's the first time in I don't know how long.
Hi, I'm sorry. I turned it back down. Go ahead.
Fucking prick.
Go ahead.
That you've had the regulars on.
Yes.
Yeah, bro.
Yep. Turn up a little bit more. Really loud.
Hey, I'll turn it down. In the other room. I'll turn it down. Go ahead.
Turn that goddamn music down.
Turn that racket off.
So, yeah, but I haven't had the regulars on in a while. Do you know understand why?
Christ. Why?
Yeah, well, he hasn't been around. He hasn't been. None of you guys have been around.
You're doing I'm the around show every week.
Like I said, the regulars.
You're doing the show at night. It's hard to do at nights because I'm a comedian.
It's been hard for me to do the show, but I've become very fond of Will Sylvince.
Ugh.
He's just a little black.
Yeah.
Jesus, guys.
I love Will, man.
Not in this fucking, not in,
dude,
what's
I love
going
him.
On?
In these times. You're right.
We're
I love
getting,
Will.
We're
He's
getting
great.
Diverse. The show's diverse now. Will, Deepu.
Well, we had the girls are on a lot of girls coming on lately.
Mm-hmm. Lewis is Puerto Rican.
But
I'm just saying it's a little hurtful. I've been around. Joe's been around.
He hasn't been around. He wasn't. He was away.
They've been doing the show at night.
Yeah, I text Joe. He doesn't respond. So
no, Joe was away. Actually, you were. I actually talked to you. You were away somewhere.
So it's just me.
Huh?
It's just me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that's my bone to pick. You singled me out.
I don't know what you're talking about. I had you host it. You've always been like, dude,
was
let me host.
Was that the first person you asked to host?
I hope
yes,
one.
You were. He was, yes. Actually, yeah.
Right. What the? Why does it? Always, why do you have to have
Hold
this?
On.
Is it because
Bobby,
you don't
do you
have
want a... your own segment, Bobby's Bones?
No, I don't.
That sounds way better. It's alliteration.
What I'm saying is, why do you need that? Why did you need that moment?
Well, I just felt like we haven't been on in a while together, and I wanted to know why.
I would love to
because
have
Dan has a career.
And yep. We undug
Joe's
the bones.
Getting a career, and you threw away an almost career. So now you're going to move back to L.A.
I really wish.
Oh, that's awesome. Remember when you almost moved to L.A.?
Oh, dude, that was
Are you really
crazy.
Are you going to move to L.A.?
I wish, dude.
Why?
Just move.
Dude, I'm in the middle of the fucking worst situation of my life.
What do you mean? What happened?
Yeah, let's talk about it.
Oh, shit. We moved into an apartment.
Mm-hmm. Where?
In Harlem.
First mistake.
That is racist, Dan.
I didn't. Yeah, why
did you go to Harlem? Why don't you just go to fucking Astoria like these queers?
Because we want a backyard. We really want a backyard.
You can get
a backyard in Astoria.
We searched up and down high and low. Story.
I'm sure you were high.
Why don't you just use the park as your backyard?
Because you can't let my dog is a psychopath with balls. Okay, he's a Jack Russell Terrier. He's got his balls.
Why is
if
he
I take him to the park,
chop him off.
A pit bull is gonna snap his fucking neck because my dog likes to fight pit bulls and Rottweilers.
Why don't you get your dog neutered?
Because he's too old at this point.
No,
dude.
He's not.
It's like fucking neutering Bobby Kelly at this point.
I mean,
I'm pretty much neutered, dude. Yeah, I'm.
You're neutered.
I haven't done shit. I get home late. I go to bed early. I wake up early. I don't do shit. I don't even jerk off that much anymore. It's a sad fucking thing.
He naps with a cone around his head.
You want me to jerk you off, buddy?
I would love it.
You got nice lips.
What do you want to do to you? I don't want to fucking suck your
just
dick for
pout
that.
Your lips. All right. Like I'm pouty.
I see, this is where I don't... Is he gay?
No.
You should put your dog down, bro. That's what I would do. I don't know. Is that crazy?
Can I be honest, though?
That might be the funniest thing Jonas has ever said.
Listen, I mean... So what's your problem? I really want to know. So you're in this apartment. What's the deal? You're
so
in Harlem.
We show up on the 1st with our stuff.
Yeah.
And
here's what happened. Lewis didn't know it was a black neighborhood.
No, I did.
Oh.
So we show up, and the apartment was supposed to just be ready. Uh-huh. Just ready. I mean, we signed the lease, did a walkthrough. They said nothing. Yeah. There's no problems with the apartment. Yeah. We show up. There's 4 fucking dudes in the apartment.
Yeah.
Fucking.
And they're just having gay sex right in my kitchen.
What's the address?
I don't know what's going on with you, dude. I really don't.
I love
me.
It.
Yeah, you.
I'm kidding.
Yeah, but I don't know when you're kidding.
So
usually a joke comes right out. I mean, a laugh.
There's smoke billowing out of the apartment, dude. They're like dust and smoke billowing out of the apartment. They're doing construction on the ceilings.
Okay.
It's in the rain on the 1st.
Okay.
I have my entire moving crew.
Right.
Oni. I have a hammer fisting team.
It was not me, actually, this time.
Not Scopo this time. And my baby in the rain, and we can't go into this apartment because there's dust everywhere.
Okay.
So she puts us up for the night, whatever.
She put you up. Who's she?
The landlord.
Put you up where?
In a hotel.
What hotel?
So what hotel?
Hilton.
Oh, up
downtown.
Chelsea.
Ooh,
that's great.
Very
not
nice.
Bad. Okay. It's not great.
Okay.
It's not great. Nothing's great.
The Hilton's nice.
The hotel, yeah, okay. This is such like...
I love a good Hilton.
Tell us about the comics, dude. They're like, what, dude? Fucking cutting out the breakfast. That's awesome. Okay. It's awful. I'm with my child at night. He's supposed to go to bed in an hour. I'm showing up with my belongings.
I understand. I understand that. Well, I mean, it's your fault for moving at 6 in the afternoon.
Yeah, it's a little
Who the
late.
Fuck does that?
We couldn't get to the storage facility until... Dude, it's just please.
Why couldn't you get to the storage
Why
facility?
Why do I have to go backwards now? Can't I move
because
forward with the story?
No, you yeah, have sure. to tell the... Why couldn't you go to the storage facility?
Because I called the day before Thanksgiving.
Right.
I wanted to get our stuff on the Sunday, and they were closed from the day before Thanksgiving until the Monday.
Because
they
it's a holiday.
Yeah, but they just didn't tell anybody. A storage facility closes at the end of the month.
I guarantee there were signs.
There weren't. There was nothing. They didn't send an email. They were just like, yeah, sorry. It's like a mom-and-pop shop storage facility.
Okay.
We're sad.
That's your problem right there. Don't go to mom-and-pop.
I know. I should have went to fucking...
Hey, Courtney,
go to the Walmart. Yeah.
So, okay. So you can't get your stuff out when you wanted it.
So I had to speak to them Monday morning
yeah.
to set up a time.
Yeah.
Set up for 3:30 in the afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
Boom, truck goes there. We get all the shit out of the storage facility. We go over to the spot at 6 o'clock at night in the fucking hood with my baby in the rain. And
right. Where's your chick?
With me.
Okay. Is she mad at you?
No, not yet.
She
she figures out a way to blame it on me. Don't you worry. She figured out a way to blame it on me.
She's going to
blow. So she fucking.
Maybe you should put your girlfriend down.
I think it's all coming to putting him down.
Is that even a possibility?
I think all the problems go away if he goes down. Go ahead. So what happens?
So we go to the hotel that night. The next day, we moved our stuff from like 2 hours later. We went to get. I brought my entire. I brought my entire moving crew to Popeyes, and I bought everybody Popeyes.
And you're talking about
in
who?
The hood.
Who is it? Oni.
Oni's there.
Yeah.
A few comics. Some other dude, Kenny DeForest.
Okay. So you guys load all the stuff in the apartment. She holds the baby in the truck.
We don't know. We don't load the stuff yet. After we eat, we load the stuff in the apartment. Now
you
she goes
and
to the
then
hotel.
Load the stuff?
Yeah, because the smoke fucking, they had to finish up. They needed another hour to finish.
What were they doing?
Insulating the ceilings, which she had never mentioned before we were moving into the place.
That's good, though. That's good to insulate.
It's not fucking good to not have it done.
Huh? What the fuck did you just say to
it's
me?
It's not good to not have it done.
It's good to have it done. It's the same way. That's what I said. We said the same thing.
No.
Except you said it.
To not have the project finished.
It's good that it's done, though, because now you have insulated ceilings.
Shut the
so you're
fuck
not cold.
Up.
You guys are like two foreigners teaching each other English. You're like, it is good for the wall to go up. You're like, no wall, the go the wall no go up.
You know that Todd Barry joke? Eggnog. Eggnog.
All right, so, okay, so now you take all your fucking open micers to go
yeah.
for Popeyes.
We get Popeyes in the
do
hood.
They, can they get whatever they want?
Yeah.
We got, or is there a limit, a $6
well, no,
limit?
We, no, we got fucking, I got like.
Because
like,
I take somebody out, whatever the fuck
I said, well, whatever, what do you guys want? We all got buckets of chicken
what
and
do you
sides.
Want or whatever you want?
Two you guys are splitting a number six. Two you guys are splitting a number
I got them
seven.
One chicken strip and a fries to split for every two.
And you guys be very conservative with the honey mustard.
Bobby, can you take us out after this?
Yeah.
Great.
Really?
Whatever we want? Whatever we want?
No.
Why not?
I want to make sure I like it.
What Del Frisco's.
Yeah, you crazy?
Maybe.
Pizza. 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 Pizza.
Why don't we go to Cuba?
What's Cuba?
The country?
No, you
no, I think they have an embargo treaty.
No, there's a great...
You have to go to Canada before you can go.
It's my favorite restaurant, a block over.
Is it Cuban food?
Yeah, like they got beautiful steaks and chickens and rice and plantains and salads and
plantains. It's on LaGuardia, right?
Plantations.
No, it's no. one
they
over.
They slaves?
What about Bear Burger? You want to go to Bear
Burger? Yeah, Bear Burger!
I just came from Bear Burger.
All right, forget it.
We well, you Bear know, Burger. We'll go we'll go one-on-one, buddy.
No.
I'll tell you how much I love
what
you.
The
you guys
want
to go to dinner after?
I want to go to dinner, but you have to pay.
I know.
I got a 7:30 show. Can we do it in between 5 and 7:30?
If we stop talking about it and pick a place, where do you want to go?
Where
do you want to go, Dan? You
don't ooh, like, let's put a bunch of places in a hat.
I go everywhere.
Huh?
Put a bunch of places in a hat, and then we fucking choose some places we're going to go.
You really had no childhood. You're still living games out.
Yeah, and don't take off your hat. Your head's
how about I shut my eyes for 10 seconds?
That wasn't a joke. That was a statement.
That was a joke.
All right.
That was an awful okay. joke.
All right, so I got to get back. All right,
we should get tacos across the street.
Tacos are good, but...
come on.
I mean, I'd rather go to the fucking Vietnamese place.
Oh, like would you?
That place,
I told
you,
you
don't
never,
like it?
I told you I'd never go back to Vietnam. Yeah, I'll take that man.
What do you want, pizza? Or
I like anything, bro.
Let's go pizza.
Oh, dude, if
let's go
pizza!
To John's.
Pizza!
Let's go to John's.
Want to go to John's?
No, yeah. I mean Joe's.
The one in the corner?
No, John's. It's one that's an actual
dude,
restaurant.
The grandma slice right there. That's the best slice in New York.
Bro, we eat Ben's all the fucking time,
guys,
dog.
This is, it literally just sucks right now.
No, it doesn't. They love it, the fans.
Where do you want
to
go?
Go to the chat room. What are they saying about our discussion?
We'll have that.
We got a guy
anybody,
from...
We're the chat room. We'll decide where we go for dinner.
Perfect.
I don't, like, I don't like this at
we
all.
We got a guy from...
I thought you were corporate.
We got a guy from Norway watching.
Really?
Right now, yeah.
What's his name?
Tweet at us. Turgi... Hoosland?
Sounds made up.
Are you sure it's not fucking Deepu's dad?
Yeah, I don't know. Right there.
On Deepu.
All right, so I got to get back to the story. I got to hear this.
So, yeah, the next
day. Stop yelling.
Sorry.
Remember you said don't eat the mic? Sorry. All right, so you're in the, you take them all out to Popeyes. Everybody gets like a number six. You eat your food.
I get a whole family meal.
Okay, so you go back and you load up the house. Then what?
Load up the house. B goes down to the hotel. We all load up the house.
What time is this?
Now it's like 7:30, maybe?
7:30. Okay. So you do this in an hour and a half.
So it's dark. It's
oh,
dark.
No. Oh, we probably finish around, I guess, 8. We probably finish around 8.
Okay, so it's...
So where is B with the baby? All this is happening.
She went to the hotel already.
So she's down at the Hilton.
Watching
yeah,
Jeopardy.
She went, yeah.
Right, she's showing. In the hall. She's taking a bath while the baby's she's sleeping.
Baby's sleeping, she's rubbing one out.
Right.
Really stressful day of fucking moving a baby around.
Just thinking about just
dude,
strong,
that's very stressful,
muscly
dude.
Movers.
Yeah.
You don't think it's... Jesus, why are you being passive aggressive to your chick?
Anyway.
What the fuck are you doing right
so,
now? No. You don't think it's stressful to deal with a kid all
I
day?
I deal with a kid every day. Welcome to my life.
Lewis's second segment.
Lewis's life.
You're in my life, baby.
Welcome back to
you're gonna bomb.
Lewis's life with Lewis J. Gomez.
All right, so now you go back up, you move all the shit up, and then what?
So we move all the shit, then I go to the hotel.
Mm-hmm.
We hang out.
What do you do with the guys? Wine. Where are the guys?
The guys, I pay them
you
to go home.
You drink wine in the hotel?
Yeah.
Where'd you get that?
A wine store?
So you went and bought
you
wine?
Fucking, where would I get
I
just, wine?
I don't, I can't, I mean, what?
I found it by a lake.
Yeah, but does your wine have a handle on it? Is it like a finger holder?
That's a good one.
Can you give him the fucking bomb band? I don't even know what he's going for.
So this might be your problem. This might be your problem,
Lewis.
That
was a good fucking... A wine with a handle?
That's good.
Good
wine.
That's a fucking... That's not
good. Is it Carlo Rossi's good wine?
No, yeah, my grandma used to drink
But there's
it.
Only
it's
one
wine.
Not good wine, you
hey,
piece
I'm
of
not
garbage.
Hitting him out of the park today, but I'm fucking swinging. And you cocksuckers... Dan, you know what? I'd rather take the bandana than your fucking just... saying it was a good one without even laughing.
Now, why are you
that's passive aggressive?
You know what? Because you had no seasoning on it. Just because it's a plain ass joke.
Don't
and
try
then
to.
This Goomba says that it's good wine because it's Carlo Rossi.
Yeah, my grandma. My grandma Carlo Rossi.
My grandma drank it all the
you
time.
See? Yeah. You're getting his head. Now we're going to have to deal with 75 characters over the next hour.
And that's just what's going
to
happen.
You challenge him to fucking be funnier, and every 3 minutes we're going to have like, ah, you fucking mighty. Ah,
that'd be pretty good. I haven't done pirate in a long time.
I like the pirate. What is
well, you know what? It'll be there. I don't know. No, I'm not getting baited into it.
Yeah. Just let him sit in the pocket and have some jokes so I don't have to deal with.
Career.
I don't deal with Robin Williams over here.
I like fucking. First of all, I like his characters.
Thanks, dude.
And they're very funny and fun to listen to. And I've liked them from day one. Even when DeRosa tried to bully me out of
and I'll tell
fucking
you this,
Dan Soder's characters.
It's true.
You want to talk about day one? I'll go back to fucking 89, sitting in his dumb fucking apartment that has 8 bedrooms and no windows that he still lives in, even though he makes $375,000 a month.
I do.
You make that a
no window.
I wish.
Soda was like, you know, we're smoking pot, and Soda's over here doing like a pitch perfect pirate, and it goes into an Indian, and I'm like, you gotta do these, you'll be a millionaire, you fucking Nimrod. And he goes, well, I don't want to be a hack that does voices.
It's true. Yeah.
And I fucking shook him by the collar, and now look at
be
him.
Be a hack.
I should be.
Be a fucking hack, man.
I convinced him to be a hack, and now I don't get any money from it.
Working out pretty well. Women and ladies, y'all look beautiful tonight. clap it up for yourselves, ladies.
I have one last thing.
By the way, I'm still at Popeyes in this story.
I Lewis, got you, buddy. Don't think
I'm going
back
to that.
Back to you. I'm going.
Your problem, yeah. I think. And we saw a little nugget of it. Wouldn't you say, Bobby? You think that you're the only one struggling or suffering. You go, oh, yeah, I'm moving. It's raining. I got to buy Chipotle or chicken, whatever the fuck, bullshit.
Yeah.
And you're meanwhile, your wife down here, she's taking care of the baby. It's also raining for her. And you don't go, she's struggling, too. This is difficult. It's just you having a tough time. Yep. And she's got it easy with her feet up at the Hilton.
He's self-centered.
She literally had her feet up at the Hilton.
He was.
She literally had her feet up at the Hilton, though.
You know what,
though? But she's supposed to have her feet up in her own house.
That's your queen, dog.
That's your job. That's as the man of the house.
She's the queen.
So that your queen and your child is in the...
I'm going to murder my fucking landlord.
Soder, act out a queen, please.
That's it.
I'm the queen of Lewis. This is your son.
It's more of a Kelly.
Yeah, dude. She's not supposed to be down in a hotel. She's supposed to be
He's
her
like,
own.
I need you lifting boxes out in the rain.
So
lift a box and the kid.
I want wine. I have the taste for wine.
So... The next day, we're supposed to move in at 1.
Mm-hmm.
She was like, we need to paint.
How
is,
did
we
you
need to paint.
Did she drink wine with you?
Yeah.
Ooh. So you got a little, you tied one on? Look, a little buzzy? Did you get a little buzzy? Did you get high before you went back to the hotel?
Yeah.
Of course you did. Yeah, you're a stoner.
I had to.
So you're a stoner now. We can just say that about you.
Yeah, I'm just a stoner.
You're just a fucking stoner.
Yeah.
Okay, so as long as you admit it. I hate fucking guys.
Well, no, I was fighting it a little bit.
Now you're just a pothead.
Can I say, this is
that's
where it's
not
all...
the only thing I am. I am a pothead, but I'm many other things.
Great,
but
great
it's the
dad.
First thing we know about you.
But also, this is a matter of perspective, because you're going, blah, 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 and she's down there, but she might be sitting in the Hilton going, I'm watching the baby all day. Lewis is getting high and hanging out with his friends.
Popeye's
and,
chicken.
And eating fucking Popeye's with his buddies.
She had Popeye's too.
Yeah, but of course she did. She's like, fucking hungry.
She's like, he's doing his
I'm
favorite
just
thing.
Saying,
she's a queen, right, Dan?
Yep.
I'm just saying there's two perspectives.
Queen.
So here's the
queen
deal.
B.
So you go back down, you drink some wine. Do you guys fool around a little? Do you get a little bit?
What's going on, bro?
We're the baby sleeping next to us.
All right.
Why not? Can you get a blowjob in a tub?
No.
She hates him, that's why.
What?
Scopo.
Why would you say that?
Yeah, why you gotta come in like true, that?
What, do you talk to her?
He's like,
me and B have a good relationship.
Bro, I've been on the phone with her, bro.
Oh, that made me so happy if she's cheating on Lewis with fucking
dude.
Scopo. Oh, would I fucking love life. If I
what gate would be opened up?
If I'm walking down, if I was walking by like one of the clubs down here past the cellar, and I saw Scopo making out with B.
Or they're holding hands over a table.
In like Cafe Reggio.
Yeah.
Late at night.
Just talking.
And she's going over his jokes. And she's laughing. Oh, I like that one.
She's showing him sketches she's done. And he's like...
Scopo's buying jokes from B.
He goes, these are really good. These are really good sketches.
What do you think about these sketch ideas, B?
Do you think Bobby's mad at me?
Do you think she calls him up? Well, you know, he did it again. Listen, like, you got it. Look, he loves you. He's trying to give her.
On. But he does one of these. Let me go outside real quick. What are you thinking?
I don't
you
want okay? my mom. I'm going outside.
Ma,
right outside.
Ma.
Dude, mom, put my pork chops in the microwave.
I told
Parmesan. And then a few weeks later, he's like, I fucked up, Bobby. I fucked up big time. I never should have started in with this broad.
All right, so you go back to the hotel. You wake up the next day. What happens?
So we're supposed to be back there. They're supposed to be
your psycho bobbing shit that you do before you murder a whole fucking room. Do you see that?
They're all gonna pay.
That is.
I used to do that. I used to do that when in like elementary school.
Rocking. You can look it up. Rocking is a sign of mental illness. Dude, it is a fucking.
You know
fact.
What, dude?
If people who do this are mentally ill or they're reading the fucking Quran.
If rocking makes you crazy, I don't want to be sane.
By the way, Lewis has never murdered a room. He's done all right a couple times, but it was at LOL.
Okay, so go ahead. Next day.
So we're supposed to get back at 1. I tell her, I call the landlord up. I was like, oh, we'll be back at 3. They're supposed to paint, and then we're supposed to come in, and they're supposed to clean up all the shit. Because we brought all of our shit into, like, dust everywhere.
Right.
So all of our furniture's in this dusty apartment. Yeah. So we get there at 1. They're still not fucking done. God. Really ghetto fucking construction guys that she hired from, like, the neighborhood.
Right.
One of the guys, they're finished. He was like, oh, finally, it was Scopo. He was like, oh, finally, bro.
I didn't help you this time. No. That was the last 17
times. It was a ghetto guy, and he was
shit. Scopo really doesn't like you today. Go ahead.
So he's like, yo, I've been waiting for this all day. And he pulls out a flask and starts drinking in my living room.
Right.
In front of my baby. And I'm sitting there, I was like, this is the guy who's just like, is in my house right now drinking. So they go to leave, and I'm just kind of like, oh, it's a nightmare. Dude, the place smells of paint. There's still sawdust everywhere drywall shit.
Yeah.
So
dust. Just regular dust.
We start.
Don't be specific.
We start.
Specific or Pacific. Go ahead.
We start looking at the ceilings, and they're still cracking.
Oh, my God.
I can't believe it.
Oh, my God.
They're still fucking cracking.
My God.
And at this point, I would like to introduce my third segment, Louis J. Gomez, Home Repair.
Here we go.
Let me get a little music.
Time to repair with Louis J. Gomez.
I was there.
Sponsored by Binford.
Fuck Soder all up now.
Soder's not. Soder,
yeah, you took
close
away,
down.
You took away his character confidence, you fucking asshole.
Soder, listen.
He who giveth can taketh away.
Look at me. Stay with me. Soder, Danny, look at me. Stay with me. Ready? Stop it. I mean it. Stop it! I mean it!
Anybody like a peanut?
He's back!
Danny is back! I'm gonna sit up in my chair.
All right.
Oh, man, I really want to do a black voice for that guy drinking out of the flask. There was so much ground to cover.
Come on, buddy. Let's get in it.
If Lewis is going to be doing segments, we're all going to be on our best performances here.
We are going to have to. Really
I'm a setup guy. You guys can do the punches, okay?
So anyways, back to B cheating on you with Scopo.
No, that's not. We're past that.
Nope. Okay. Back to you eating chicken like a savage.
I would love
that.
Past.
We're past that.
You said savage.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, no. That's an old thing. And only Lewis can trigger that.
Yeah, we call Lewis
I got
savage.
Happy in that one.
Here's the deal. The savage. I mean, yeah.
I wanted a Randy Savage.
So the next day, the guy's drinking a flask in front of your kid.
So we get there.
Which, you know, I mean, he's probably, you know, he's going to smell you and see you smoking weed his whole life. I don't know why a flask is throwing you off.
I don't even really care that much.
At least they hit it.
Look, here's the thing. In reality, I get it. She's hiring local
guys. What about
guys.
In the fourth dimension?
In the fifth dimension?
If I use my third eye.
No, let's go back to reality. Go ahead, reality.
In reality, I get why she would hire these ghetto fucking guys.
Yeah.
You know, I get it. You're going to save a little bit of money. Mm-hmm. You know, they're nice guys. Maybe who gives a shit? I drink. I smoke pot. Who cares?
Yeah, you
know?
So
they leave.
Yeah.
We start to see cracking in the ceiling again.
God damn it.
So I'm like, holy shit. So I call her up. She's like, yeah, we're going to have to come in and redo the ceilings.
Oh,
you guys are going to have to leave for another day and then another day to come back and paint.
Okay.
So at no point has she literally, she hasn't even said I'm sorry yet.
Why is this happening?
I don't know.
You understand?
We signed the lease. There was no talk of there being any construction.
But no. Did they say why it's cracking again?
No.
That's just weird.
She hired fucking animals from the neighborhood to do the fucking job that
now
don't know
animals.
What they're doing.
Now they're animals.
Yeah.
These guys are hardworking dudes.
No, and the one of them tells me, he's like, yo, man, don't be mad at her because by the way, we weren't even that mad. We were actually pretty cool about it considering the fact that we're going through all this shit. I didn't lose my cool. I'm Puerto Rican, so my instincts, I was like, I'm going to get kicked out of this place. I try to, like, really be...
We get it. You're Puerto Rican.
Yeah, okay. Stop being Eric Rivera. We get it. You're Spanish.
Spanish people are weird because we look at this like this. What happened?
Do you guys want to keep on going with this thing?
We're trying to pick it up because your fucking retelling of the story is awful.
In reality.
Everyone keeps on fucking stopping the story.
I'll go back to you calling black people animals.
Hey, all right, so what did this guy say?
I didn't mean it that way. I did not mean it that way.
What did this guy say to you? You're on camera.
You're on camera, you retarded.
Listen.
Hey.
Well, so what did this guy say?
What, the landlord?
No, the guy just said, why are you so mad?
Oh, he was like, yeah, don't be mad. The last guy she hired stole all of her tools, so that's why this got pushed back. So that she had to hire us to come in and finish the job.
Okay.
So this guy's telling me this. I'm like, dude, I don't fucking care. I don't even care.
Okay, so now you're out of the thing again. Okay.
So no, I'm not out of the thing again. Okay. So I tell her, I was like, look, I'm pretty upset here. I was like, you haven't even said I'm sorry. And over again, now you're telling us they have to do more construction, get all of our stuff covered in dust and sand.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Then paint. We have to be out of the house another 2 full days. I was like, this is kind of being crazy now.
Right.
I was like, what happened? They did is they came and they woke up my baby. They're supposed to like fix the kitchen sink and like put a mailbox on. And they came and they woke up the baby. They left and they came back.
Yeah.
And that was my last thing. I was like, they come back. They wake up my kid. You have these guys coming into my house that obviously aren't professional contractors. Right. I was like, at what point is enough enough? I was like, we're 5 days into this fucking. I didn't even curse. I was like, we're 5 days into this, and I was like, it is just nonstop us having to deal with the brunt of this, and you have a very blasé whatever attitude. So
ooh,
not me,
blasé?
Her, right?
Her. I used to blasé.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, okay, go
I spoke French to this bitch.
Okay, he's the mayor, right? Blasé.
All right, go ahead. So what happened?
So she ends up writing me a thing being like, you know, if you want out of your lease...
You wrote a letter?
I'm sorry. I'm kidding, dude. I'm kidding.
She wrote me a text saying, I'm literally going to peg this at your fucking head. I swear, I'm going to fist fight
just
you.
Just go ahead.
You're going to have a big red patch across your face for
just
the last day.
Lewis, we want to hear the legalities of your rent agreement. Please continue.
Continue with the.
Could you read me the second clause in here?
I would like the nuances in chapter A.
Can you
and
read me the rider to your lease just verbatim?
In 1962, they passed the Civics Rights Renters Agreement, which means technically at this point, I'm allotted. What happened?
Right, so what happened?
Dan ran out of real estate.
You tell that.
I just watched Dan run out of real estate.
But here's the deal.
Okay. I'm not going to lie. Wasn't that meaty of a premise?
Here's the deal. You give her this big, long fucking Louis J. Gomez speech. You use all the big words.
Yeah.
You say your R's.
Like the white.
Right? You say all your R's. You pronounce things correctly.
Yeah.
Show her that you're well-read almost.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And what happens?
She texts me saying, if you guys want out of your lease, you guys can get out of your lease.
Word?
Yeah, I'll let you out of your lease.
Wow.
Yeah.
But that's not what you wanted.
We wanted her to be slightly apologetic.
You didn't want her to call you bluff. You wanted her to just say, you wanted her to say, sorry, I fucked up. You didn't want her to go get the fuck out.
She didn't say get the fuck out. She
said, basically, she's going, look,
no,
take your shit and leave. I'll sell it to somebody else.
She's like, that's like a hot chick move.
That's what she's
like,
saying.
If you want to break up with me, fucking break up with me.
Yeah.
So what happened?
So then I told her, I was like, yeah, we will break our lease. I was like,
really?
Yeah. I was like, we will. I was like, we expect you to pay for the move to the next apartment. We expect our security deposit back immediately.
Do you have a lawyer on
retainer? I have
retainer? Thank
two
you.
Lawyers.
You have what? Two lawyers.
They are both girlfriends of comics that I know.
Okay, so you have two lawyers to fucking sue this bitch.
So,
into the mic.
How did she respond to this?
So I said I need the budget to move for the next move. I said I need my security deposit back right away.
Okay.
And I said if we move before January 1st, we need the prorated amount back for the rest of the month.
Right.
She said, no, I don't accept those terms.
Ooh.
Okay.
Ooh.
Okay.
This is getting into some juicy legal gossip.
I'm going to go outside. I'm going to go outside to the man on the street with the people. What do you got out there,
dum-dum,
man?
Dum-dum.
You know, guys like Lewis right now is in the wrong. This lady's just trying to approve the place he lives. I don't let Puerto Ricans into my apartment.
I like the way he's standing up for himself and his family. This is Christmas time. People should have empathy for people. We should all love each other and help each other out. It's not fair.
I'm gay. I'm a gay man. And I'm hiding here. At the courtroom.
Okay, go ahead. Go ahead. So what happened? So she called your bluff.
No, so yeah, she says that. And I basically, look, we're both, here's the truth.
Some of it's been a lie.
By the way, this is good for your legal counsel to broadcast
reality,
this on a podcast.
This is the truth. I don't give a shit.
This is how you want to do it.
All right, in reality, this is the truth.
In reality,
now, do you
this
have
is the truth.
Fourth dimension lies?
By the way,
here after this,
if her lawyer fucking pulls this up and it just has you saying "sand n word,"
you're done.
It's over. You lose.
Yeah,
she's Filipino.
Oh,
doesn't matter.
That's half Asian, half Spanish. Incredible workers.
All right, go ahead.
I call them rice niggers.
What the fuck?
What, dude? What?
Come on.
What? You got to stop.
You have to name the podcast Rice Nigger. Yeah, that's a good name for the podcast.
Dude, are you out of your mind?
I'm just kidding.
You are never getting
I'm Hispanic. I'm allowed to say these words.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
Yeah. No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
You're a fucking round eye, bro. Dude,
yeah, man. You can't be talking shit about almond
eyes. I'm allowed to say the N-word.
Here's the deal. Next time you're on some show and you call me, hey, bro, you know that episode?
No, I made you take a video of me sucking your fake cock down in front of a crowd while they cheered me on.
That was,
a little extreme.
That's less than, I think
that
people,
was some of the accused.
Way less
that
offensive.
That was like the accused. Everyone was cheering Lewis.
First
was
of all,
like, I'm doing this
it
for
wasn't
success.
Even,
Bobby, you throat raped me in front of a crowd. Yeah, we had to take that down.
Oh, first of all, I didn't do anything.
You went hard
you
on that.
You sucked my dick.
Yeah, dude, you
I was drunk. Hold on, by every legal standard, I was drunk.
Yeah.
You were in a position of power over me. Bill Cosby to me. You're in a position of power. You're a fucking comic that I looked up to and respect. Everyone was cheering me on. I didn't know
you
what was going on.
You had to get
on.
Up and put your
that's
hands
all it
up.
Takes for
I didn't
to
know what
guy's
was going
dick.
On, dude.
All it takes for Lewis is to respect somebody and have a little buzz.
Bobby Kelly raped me.
Lewis is like, hey, Bobby.
Hashtag that. Bobby Kelly raped the rattlesnake.
Dude, come on.
Bobby, is it cool if I come over and watch you eat curry?
Don't say he raped you. He's about to be on a short-lived.
Sit down.
All right, so here's the deal. So now...
By the way, that is a good point, though. I was genuinely drunk. I was... Yeah. You are genuinely in a position of power.
I'm not going to lie.
If I was a woman... That they would literally, they would make that into a thing.
No, there'd be video evidence. Yeah, there's video evidence of you reaching his.
You stuck your hands between my.
Yeah, there's video evidence that I give a great hummer. Anyway, keep on moving.
You really do, bro.
Unreal,
dude. You suck dick the way I like.
I know.
Get my dick sucked.
I said, give me the chair. You're like, dude, I'm not gonna sit down. I was like, it's not for you. Yeah. I was like, it's not for you to sit on. I was like, put your leg up.
He put my leg up. I was like, oh my God, this is a better way to get your
how
dick
weird
up.
Is it? It's like seeing a love from a past life in a different body. No? All right.
I wish you were that person and you weren't here now.
I wish Dan would die.
Oh, dude.
What the fuck? How do you go
why
from
you jump like that?
Like your dog shit?
I'm kidding, everyone.
Well, you already dropped the fucking RN word.
Dude.
All right.
I'm well on board. I'm going to call your landlord personally and tell her I got a lawyer to counteract this.
Hey, so what happened?
So now we're back. Kind of at a standstill.
You're at a standstill. And you're still in the place.
Yeah.
Are the ceilings still cracked?
Yeah.
So you won't let these people in to fix it?
No, I told them they can't come in.
Why?
Because I don't want them to come to the place if we want to leave.
So what are you going
to
do?
So I think we're just going to fucking borrow the money from friends and family and just move early and then just be in debt. We're going to take it on the chin. That's that. What are you going to do? Here's the option. Or
does
I
this place have an outside?
Yeah, really nice big backyard.
Why
private.
Don't you fucking stay?
No, because.
And let them fix
can I tell you why?
It and take it on the
can
chin
I tell
that
you why?
Way.
Because we're not going to be here more than a year. She's not going to end up renewing our lease. Mm. I'm not jumping all over the place. Dude, we want a place for the next 3-4 years until we want to go fucking buy a place.
Okay.
That's it, dude. We're not trying to move around.
Even where are you going to go?
When is this coming out?
This is coming out Monday.
Okay, we already put in an application for another place.
Where?
118th and
stop picking your nose, please. You're making me feel like
you're gonna be like right by Tom's Diner.
I have long nostril hairs.
Yeah, trim them.
I pull them out. They hurt. They make me sneeze.
All right, listen. So you're gonna have another place already. Does it have a backyard?
Yeah.
And it's on 118th on the east side or
west side.
So you're on the west side now.
Yeah.
That's upper west too.
It's beautiful.
That's
up there.
Nice up there.
It's Columbia.
Nice. Where that's at is really actually really nice.
Is it cheaper?
Very slightly more expensive.
It's a little slight, like what, 25, 50 bucks?
No, like 100 bucks.
150 bucks.
That's
more.
Okay, though.
Okay.
You're paying for location.
We're paying less now than we've been paying for the past 4 years together anyway.
I mean, things are breaking.
What was that?
I think someone got shot. Yeah. That was a gunshot.
Was that?
Sound
no,
like
it was not a gunshot.
Oh, I'm bleeding. Oh.
How great.
That rice nigger shot me. That rice nigger shot me. Oh, come on, guys. Give me the bandana. Fuck off.
Give me the bandana. Why don't we give you a hood?
Hood.
Bandana.
Why don't we give you a hood?
The fucking bomb hood?
Yeah, bomb hood. You're fucking unbelievable, dude. You really
I'm just kidding,
have,
guys.
You have no, dude.
I'm just kidding.
Do you understand? You can't say that about everything.
I don't mean to be a real ass prude, but you can't be saying things like that.
No, you do whatever you want, you little fucking racist.
I'm not racist. I have been called a nigger my whole childhood by racist people in my neighborhood. Why can't I say it? Why can other Hispanic people say it, but I can't say it?
That's how racism perpetuates.
What?
Wow.
Perpetuates. Pendulums.
Is your little mouth
broken? Did I get it?
No, not at all.
Oh. Well, you know, that's how you go, well, they were racist, so I'll be racist.
Do I have any ads to read this today?
Yeah, I thought we'd do the break.
Okay. What do we got in the chat room? Where are they saying we're going?
Lauren
to hell.
Yeah.
Lauren Vagodis says, Puerto Ricans always have multiple lawyers but no money. I don't get it.
She's right. God, she's right.
You're a whore.
She's not a whore. What's wrong with you? Why can't you just take a hit?
God, it'd be great if it was his landlord.
I'm going to sue him that he is most racist person. He is like a gorilla. His baby is like half monkey. What's baby.
Someone in chat rated all the comedians on the show, 1 through 5.
Go ahead.
Why are you going to read that?
Why are you going
to
do that?
I'm going to hear it.
No. Fuck you.
I thought maybe that'd be interesting.
Yeah, that's interesting to you, fucking. You're number 5 anyways. Come
I assume
on.
You're not on the list.
Yeah, of course.
All right, fuck that. Fucking some fucking cunt rating people.
Here's my list of the top 5 comedians in the room.
Yeah, let's go.
Listen, if I'm not 5,
I want to know the fucking food place.
Oh,
Scopo had a great line.
Yeah.
Come on.
Black Osbo says Chipotle. Mega Tech Guy says a place with a lot of salads.
Oh, that's
funny. Silcom Wiz says famous original Ray's pizza.
Where is that, by the way? Every fucking Ray's is the original.
It's always the original,
Where is it? We don't know where that is.
I don't
know, all right, what else?
Give me 1 second. Kevin Vosberg says, please start the story over using lawyer speak. This was during Lewis's.
Thanks, K. Vosby. Yeah. You're the man.
I'll see K. Vosby this weekend.
I love K. Vosby.
I'll be in Tampa.
I'm watching live. He tweeted at me with the picture.
Oh, great, man. K. Vosby's the best. Yeah, if you're watching live, tweet out the picture from your computer or iPhone or whatever the fuck it is.
K. Vosby, tweet us a picture of your balls.
I don't want a picture of your balls, dude.
He's going.
Is that it?
100%. Yeah, that's it for now.
So check it out, dude. So you're going to have to move again, and you're going to get all your shit out of there, and you'll be fine.
Hopefully.
What is it? How many times is this year?
I have moved him three times this year.
You haven't moved me 3 times this year.
How many times?
I've only moved once. I moved into a sublet. It was a furnished sublet. Scopo, there was bags in your car. Stop acting like you moved me into a fucking a new building, dude. It was a car. You helped B move bags in
B
a car.
Move.
B movie? I love that movie. Seinfeld. What's the deal? I'm going to keep saying things until somebody cracks a smile.
How's the kid doing?
Oh, boy. Ooh.
What, did you just get a mood swing? You lose your energy? What the fuck's wrong with you?
I'll tell you this right now. I don't know where the magic is, but it's lacking, guys.
Yeah. Oh, come on with that.
Well, what the fuck, man?
Lewis is bringing everyone down.
I didn't bring anybody down with the racism.
He hates construction workers. That's not cool. I'm a union guy.
Yeah, I'm a union guy.
Me
too,
too,
man.
You're SAG, right?
Yeah, me too.
SAG after.
Yeah, man.
All right.
And I'm a writer's union.
Yeah. I mean, that's WGA. That's awesome.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, that's cool.
You know what else bothers me about it? It's like, I just feel like B would be better off with Scopo. You know?
Oh, absolutely. They could live in the fucking parents' house.
They live in Queens.
Yeah, have a car.
Joe and I could raise James.
First of all, Scopo's father would rather have me as a son. I will trade lives with you. I really mean that. Is that not true?
That's one of the meanest things, but also hilarious when you say, like, you're dead about me.
Can we do a house swap, me and Scopo, for one? We'll do a YKWD special?
My dad will like you for, like, 2 days. And then
that's not true.
When you don't clean up, he'll fucking kill you.
Listen to me. I'm going to be cuckolding your mom in front of your dad.
What the fuck?
That's rude.
Did you say you're going to fuck his mom?
Come on, bro.
Cuckold.
That's weird.
Yeah, that doesn't make it
better. In front of his dad.
The father's going to be there.
He's going to be jerking off.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
sorry.
Relax.
All right. I thought you were getting weird.
No.
The word cuckle is just such a dirty word, isn't it?
Overall, I'd rate the experience. I liked living there. I liked the food. Fucking his mom in front of his dad was chill. but I'm ready to go home to my son and my crack ceilings. I hope an old bathtub falls on you while you're sleeping through a crack ceiling.
Just a fucking spider bottom tub.
Just and just breaks through.
It's a spider bottom tub.
You mean I was hoping nobody noticed what I just said.
You mean it's a paw foot tub. What,
you got that one?
No, yeah. You fucking paw, it's paws. Not a paw foot. It's not paw foot. You paw fucked foot? Up too.
What is it?
Paw foot tub?
It's called the above ground.
You're a paw foot tub.
You corrected me with paw foot tub.
I think I'm right.
No, Dad, it's called the paw foot.
Somebody Google
claw
it.
Claw foot.
No, claw. No, it's not claw.
Both of you. It's a claw foot tub.
The paw foot is fucking redundant.
It's called a raised tub.
Claw foot tub.
No, a paw foot tub.
I think it's a paw foot tub.
Claw.
Guys, welcome back to public school educated assholes.
Clawfoot tub.
It sounds like
clawfoot. Clawfoot.
Yeah.
It sounds like you're trying to say profit with a speech impediment.
Pawfoot tub.
Pawfooting.
It's a pawfoot tub.
We're not going to make any pawfoot.
Pawfoot. Guys, the pawfoots are down.
I project that in 2015 we will be profitable.
I'm putting my paw foot down. I really, now we're rolling.
I really do look mentally challenged, so I'm the looking at the video. Foot. It's a paw foot.
Paw foot.
What's up, paw foot,
paw
right?
Foot's up, yeah. All right, it's not whatever. Paw foot.
At least it was in a spider foot tub. What the fuck is that?
Spider feet. What the fuck is a spider foot?
There were eight legs on that tub. It was awesome.
They have legs, not feet.
All right, listen. We're going to take a break. Hopefully.
We're going to chill out, bro. Yeah.
Hopefully Dan wakes the fuck up.
Bro, what did I just do besides Dan's tomahawk good. Dunk this energy?
Pretty good. I just think I want to talk about during the break. Hopefully your Lewis's use of the N-word. I want to talk about it because
okay, honestly,
I don't want to talk about it on air because it's more serious than that. It's serious.
Because hashtag I can't breathe.
Yeah.
How about that?
I am a minority. Fuck you. I'm going to sing a white people tell me that I can't fucking use whatever words
I want
to use.
You are a minority.
It's not white people. It's the human race.
Yeah, and also,
it's human saying, hey, let's not fucking talk like that, you moron.
As a pure-blooded Aryan warrior, you've got a little white blood in you, so be careful, bro.
Yeah, and you are a minority. You're the only racist here. Dogged.
All right, let's go to break. We'll be back. Everybody live in the room, just stay tuned. We're going to play a little music for you. What song are we picking?
Some royalty-free YouTube library music.
So all right, so check it out. Yeah. Enjoy this fucking awesome song. What's the name of the song, though? I gave you the names.
I'll put the names on the screen.
Okay, great.
I don't have them right now.
All right, and we'll be back in around 8.5 minutes.
Yep.
All right, check it out, everybody at home. DraftKings.com. Check it out. The list of millionaires crowned at DraftKings.com this football season keeps growing. And you could be next. DraftKings is America's favorite one-week fantasy football site where you can win instant cash every week. All it takes is this. Watching a football game. Oh, my God. I'm fucking this up. Totally.
You're doing a good job.
What's the noise? There's a noise. Your phone's ringing. Is it my phone? Who is it? My wife. Oh, God. Hang on 1 second.
I'm muting mics now.
Everything go. Hello.
All right.
You called me back. I was on the phone with UPS.
What happened?
They're just saying the same thing you said. It's out for delivery. That's all they know. They're running behind because of the weather and holidays and packages. And,
okay. All right. So keep your eye out.
Yeah.
All right.
It's here. Okay.
All right. It's here now?
No, I said I'm here.
Oh, okay. Goodbye.
Bye.
Just being married. Do you feel that tone? Oh, God.
UPS.
All right, what?
I ordered a bidet from UPS.
You got one?
Yeah. You know what came?
When?
Nothing. Nothing came in the box.
Are you kidding me?
Just nothing came. An empty box.
Is that from them or is that from?
I don't know. I think it was Home Depot.
You like my bidet, huh?
I didn't get it as fancy as you.
It's okay, but you like
but
it.
Yeah.
It's great for your hemorrhoid, right?
Yeah, I got to get it for the fucking hemorrhoid.
It's fucking great. Anyways, back to DraftKings.com. DraftKings, I'm going right back to the beginning, okay? Here you go. DraftKings, I love this site. For you guys who do the fantasy football site, okay? It takes watching football to a whole new level, okay, when you play with DraftKings.com. Your season-long fantasy team might be missing the playoffs, but the excitement begins again, each and every week at DraftKings.com. One player turned $10 into $5,000. I love that. I love when people can turn a couple bucks into thousands. Another turned $2 into $10,000. And new millionaires have been made nearly every week this season at DraftKings.com. So if you're a fantasy football guy, if this is your thing, this is what you want to be doing, okay? It's unbelievable. Head over to DraftKings.com now and use promo code Kelly to play free in the $10 million Fantasy Football World Championships. DraftKings.com, bigger events, bigger winners, bigger millionaires. Enter Kelly now at DraftKings.com. That's DraftKings.com. Okay? And this is another one of my favorites right here. Okay, check it out. I shave my head, I shave my face, sometimes my ass and my balls. Okay? Is there anything worse than that maximum security prison they have all those razors in at the Duane Reed or the Rite Aid? You got to go over there and either you got to stick your hand in that box that gets it's shut on, or you got to push a button and have someone come over like you're a criminal and take your razors out. It's like visiting somebody in prison. It's awful. They're behind a display case. You should put your hand up like you're saying I love you to somebody in prison. That got a little wordy, but whatever. I just can't stand it. It almost makes me want to buy crappy razors because they're right on the shelf. I can get them at a gas station. It makes it easy, but not anymore. All right, do it the smarter way. Get your razors from DollarShaveClub.com. Just for a couple bucks, DollarShaveClub.com delivers amazing razors right to you. That's it. Right to your house, right to your doorstep. Their blades are fantastic, and since they arrive like clockwork, you can shave with a fresh blade every week. Nothing feels better than that. And guess what? Women can use this too. Women shave their legs, their armpits, some of them their face.
Their vaginas.
You know, yeah. Seriously. You know, and my wife is always stealing my razors. I don't care anymore because I always have a new razor right in the drawer. It's ready to go. And if you need a great gift for the holiday, give them the club. Just sign them up. DollarShaveClub.com has gift cards at any amount which can be used for everything they sell, from their amazing razors to their other great products like Dr. Carver's Easy Shave Butter, which I have, which is awesome, which my wife used all of. Look, a gift card for a Dollar Shave Club truly is a gift that keeps giving and giving and giving. Over a million people get razors from DollarShaveClub.com. I should know because I'm one of them. I'm telling you, I get it sent to my house. Try DollarShaveClub.com/Kelly. Go there. DollarShaveClub.com/Kelly. That's DollarShaveClub.com/Kelly. Go there right now and get yourself a nice deal. Sign up. Great gift for the holidays. And make sure you go to Riotcast.com and check out all our amazing shows. We really try to handpick each show we bring to the network. We have Pete and Sebastian's show that's brand new. Show. Fucking awesome, man. If you want to listen to two of the funniest, quickest guys, and there's one thing, they can tell a story. I've been listening to the show, and they just keep you interested. They know how to tell stories in a funny, interesting way, and I just love the new podcast is awesome, and also the Brown Phillips show. Beige Phillips. Sorry, Brown. What a racist I am. Brown Phillips. Beige Phillips show. Is he beige? He's brown.
He's a little more brown.
With Dante Nero, who is a great friend, and it's a great show. And especially in the last couple weeks, very opinionated. It's great. Mm-hmm. But all the other shows, Nick DiPaolo's on the network. His fucking show is awesome. He's got his new hour special coming out on his website. You buy it directly from him. Make sure you check that out. And I want to thank everybody, every single one of you guys that donated to the YKWD gift drive. We just got a bunch more presents. We're going to be handing them out this Saturday afternoon over to NAC in New York. And then next week when we go back to Boston, we're going to be giving the gifts over to the NFI Shelter Care Alliance House to the kids over there. Again, the teenage boys, you know, if you want to buy socks, what are you doing? Settle the fuck down.
The umbrella.
I'm in the middle of a read, and you're just not even trying to be quiet. Not even trying.
An umbrella not going.
Just be fucking. No, it's not that. He noticed it.
No, it was him saying Jesus Christ.
Buddy, no. The mics are on, so I'm picking up everything. You could try to be a little less apey when you come in the room, you silverback gorilla. I hope you get kicked out of your new house. Anyways, thank you for supporting the children. Did any of you guys buy gifts for the gift drive?
Yeah, I did. Dope ass gifts.
What'd you get?
12-inch Marvel action figures.
Was that you?
Yeah.
That was awesome.
Yeah,
those were great. What'd you get?
I gave a PS1 and an Xbox.
We didn't get those.
You didn't get them?
Can't you get them Playboys for the teenage kids?
Anyways.
I gave them both, dude.
If you guys are still into doing it, you're into the chat room, just go to riotcast.com and hit the YKWD gift drive. Or go to robertkellylive.com/gifts right now. Again, that's robertkellylive.com/gifts. And you can buy a gift. Go to that page. A list of gifts are up there. And mail them. That's it. Go to that page. Pick a gift. Teenage boys. There's a bunch of stuff. Pick a gift and then mail to the address we provide. We're delivering these gifts next week. And you guys who bought already, thank you so much. You're amazing. I know, wrap it up. Joe's telling me to wrap it up. I am getting a little wordy with my own gift drive. This is the first year. Next year is going to be even bigger.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we're back, guys.
So are you.
What the fuck is that?
List came in firing.
I scripted my first 10 lines of this second half.
He was over there with a dry erase board.
All right, so what happened? Oh, okay.
Well, Soder made a joke. It wasn't bad, but I mean, going back, that was decent.
We're good. I got it. So we're back. Did you guys have fun smoking pot?
Yeah, I watched Lewis storm around. I always forget what it's like to go in public with Lewis until I'm out in public with Lewis, and then I'm like, oh, God. Because you're kind of like, this way. Hey, this way, Lewis. This way.
But, yeah, you are. It's like
he just walks wherever he wants to.
But it's like a fucking being with a...
an untrained pitbull?
No, almost trained. You know what I mean? Like, he still has his little rogue personality.
I'm not going to lie. Kind of thrills me sometimes.
Like, when it rains, I shit on the carpet, but that's the only time?
Yeah. Like, Lewis, no! Lewis!
It rained. It rained, honey. You know what happens.
I'm going to put him outside. Go outside.
No, just put him in the crate.
Go outside. I'm going to put him outside.
No, put him in the crate. Because you put him outside, he gets wet, and I got to wipe off his paws.
If you put him in the crate, though, the landlord will just kick him out.
All right, so we're back. I mean... What are you doing?
I'm drumming. I get excited. I'm gay.
Are you a drummer?
I can drum.
Really?
How's that Buddy Rich? Did you watch it?
Yeah, it was
you
awesome.
Ever watch any of those old Buddy Rich solos? Holy yeah. Testicle Tuesday. Yeah. That guy is unbelievable.
Really?
Yeah. This is really pushing Buddy Rich right now.
I know. I don't fucking like him pushing something.
You want me to play it into the microphone?
No, I don't.
This is what he's been doing.
It's crazy.
This is a new thing.
Yeah, I can drum.
I'm waiting for a fucking package. UPS comes yesterday. They leave that dumb note on the door. You know, look, man, you know me. You
still
know
the same OG,
I've said
but
hi
low key.
To you a bunch of times. It's not like I live on 118th Street. I have a backyard with a bench. Leave the package. Robert, I know it says don't sign. Just leave it.
Can I, being the most corporate one
Let
on
me
the
tell the
podcast.
Story first, and then you come in. Because
I already disagree with you.
There's more to it. So whatever. He leaves the note, the little fucking UPS note, which is annoying. I go
Dear
to
Bobby, you're fat. Love UPS.
Hey, Tub, I took it with me. Why don't you run after the van?
Your wife's got nice tits. Love UPS.
He's just What's overly disrespectful.
What's the PS? Love you. PS. What comes after that?
Joe stinks.
So anyways, I thought you had this scripted.
That wasn't bad. I love you.
Also wasn't
PS,
good.
PS. Joe stinks.
Okay,
he made it pretty good.
Okay. No, you go ahead.
No, you go. That window's gone. I was going
to
say.
All right, so here's the deal. So now I go to UPS. I go down to the place, and I wait in line, and I give them the thing, and they're like, it's still on the truck. You have to come back at 8:30 to the security window, and they will give you your package then.
8:30 at night?
8:30 at night.
Oh, shit.
So I wait. Now, you know, I'm with the kid, I'm with the fam. Me and my wife, we're going to watch a movie. We got the judge, the Robert Downey Jr.
Robert Duvall.
Oh, it was great.
Was it good?
Awesome. I get it because I'm a member of SAG Union.
Oh, I get it online because they stream it online.
They send them all.
But they send, why don't, I'm, Joe and I are SAG.
I don't get any DVDs.
What does SAG stand for?
I've been nominated.
Stupid and
gay. What have you been nominated for?
I was nominated for 2 Emmys.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, along with 600 other people, but...
Yeah.
You're Emmy nominated?
Emmy?
Well, no, it goes like this. Basically, every show has to pick people for every... Okay, we want to nominate... So they called me, and they were like, we want to nominate you for this episode of Louie.
Okay.
But if you look at the list, there's 178 people on the list.
Yeah.
And there's, like, 20 holy shit shows and famous people, and then they pick 4 or 5 of those.
Did you get really excited, though, when they said we want to nominate you?
Dude.
Did you cry?
Listen to me. No, FX called me up.
Done. I'm done with you. I'm fucking famous. I don't need you.
That's not how it would go.
And who was he supposed to be talking to in that act out?
I know.
Dawn.
Oh.
I said Dawn.
Oh. Well, take the candy out of your mouth. Get it out of
it's
your mouth.
It's a wrinkle in my throat.
I don't give a shit. Yeah. I don't like fucking candy in the microphones. It's
you
one of my
love candy and microphones.
Yeah. Your throat wouldn't hurt so much if you just spoke like a fucking human also.
Yeah, spit it out. I don't like...
I need a Ricola, dude.
Then leave.
What was that? What are you sucking on?
It's a Ricola.
I can't...
Sand Ricola.
Dude, I'll tell you why. Ready? Because that clicking sound on teeth drives me fucking batty.
Yeah, it reminds me of my second grade teacher, Mrs. McKee.
What?
Oh.
I like it.
I hate it.
It sounds almost like a horse hoof.
It sounds like dress shoes running up like the thing.
Do it again.
Hang on.
It's like tap dancing.
I like it.
I hate it.
I'm into it.
Yeah. All right, fuck it.
You know what?
Do it for the rest of the show.
I know this is your show.
Is that what you want? Yeah, all right, fuck it. You like it? I'm over. I'll take a fucking nice voting.
Okay.
All right, what do you like it?
Not really, no.
Okay, what about
you? Know about democracy?
Wait, they're not allowed to vote yet.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
His people are burning down a mosque.
What the fuck, dog?
What? Mosque? Now spit it out.
A mosque.
Wow. You said mosque. I'll rewind it. You can hear yourself saying it. A mush mouth. So,
not even the right religion, by the way.
So now I go to this fucking window at 8:30 at night, and I'm waiting. And waiting. And then I tell the lady.
How long actually was the wait?
20 minutes.
That's a long time.
That's a long wait.
Right. And there's only two people in front of me. So they're waiting even longer. So now I say to her, she goes, where do you live?
Was it a sassy black woman?
I was a Puerto Rican. Big girl, though. You know what I mean? But sassy.
Sassy Puerto Rican.
Sugar fruit person.
But she hates everybody there. She's like, oh, this motherfucker. And she's complaining to this other really hot black chick. This fuck, you know, I'm quitting. I hate this place. So now
you gotta love that New York fucking customer service.
I'm caught in this fucking weird, UPS hate triangle late at night shift.
Yeah.
And I'm like, so she goes, what's your address? I give her my address. She goes, oh fuck, because she's gonna deal with this certain lady that deals with my circle.
Okay.
All right, my map.
Okay.
And so the lady goes, yeah, it's here, but it's on it got reprocessed, so we can't get to it. I go, wait a minute. I came back here. You delivered it. Didn't drop it off. I came here. You said, come back now. I'm here now. It's here, but you can't go get it. No. I'm like, it's in the building, but you can't go fucking walk and get it.
You can't curse.
I didn't curse. I'm cursing now. So I go.
No, you can't curse in this show anymore.
Oh, sorry.
We had an incident with Lewis earlier.
So I
bummed everybody out.
So then I go. I paid to have the package. I'm here twice. She goes, it doesn't matter. I can't go get it. So the girl told me that when she hung up the phone, she goes, that bitch, she could get it. She could. She doesn't want
it. She passed the buck.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, dude. That was like an M. Night Shyamalan movie.
But I was so mad. I'm like,
it did stink.
I don't know. I know. But here's the thing. I'm so fucking mad. I'm coming home. I had the argument with the lady in the car, full throttle.
Oh fake argument?
But I'm talking.
That's the thing alcoholics
I was
do.
Fucking going,
is it?
You fucking go get the fucking package.
Yeah.
I paid for something. You fucking get it.
I do that.
I deserve one. And literally, I caught myself and I started laughing. I went, oh my God, I'm fucking insane. I'm fucking nuts.
You had a shower argument.
A what?
A shower argument.
Yeah, in the car.
Yeah. You can do shower arguments anywhere, but that is the best place to do them is in the shower with the water coming in your face, and you're like,
oh.
You replay instances from like seventh grade where you're like, yeah, I did buy these jeans at Target, but you know something else, and you got a zing loaded.
Yeah. I'm gonna replay. Chris asked me to do this podcast and be like, nah.
Okay, that was kind of mean.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna replay it when you do that and go, yay.
Yeah.
He said no.
We're going to replay it and you don't blink as much. See, I can be mean too, Joe.
Yeah.
I'm not being mean.
That was a mean thing to say.
Oh, shut up, you little pot face.
Well, you know.
That's the most adorable laugh ever.
I mean, the UPS story wasn't the most amazing. This is the problem.
You should have opened with the UPS story, and then we should have ended with my life deconstructing in front of everybody's eyes.
Yeah, but
here's
the deal. You went out, guys. This is the problem with you fucking stoners. You went out and got stoned, and now you're just staring at me.
I'm bringing it.
Yeah, no, you're not, but he's looking at me like he's in another planet right now. Like, my eyes are doing weird shit.
Well, I'm not
going to
lie, dude. You really, I just noticed now how little hair you have on you. It's just these little fucking sprouts of eyebrows.
That's what weed does.
That's the only
it changes hair the way a person faces.
Anywhere like. On you, dude. And then the knuckles of your feet, because I did have to touch them.
Lewis,
you had a little bit of hair on your feet knuckles.
I don't.
That was 3 years ago.
Hey, do we still have those days?
Are we doing fucking Yankee Swap?
Yeah, we are.
Fuck yeah,
not
dog.
Today.
Am I not invited?
Yeah, you're invited, dude.
Next week, bro.
When is it?
What the fuck is your... Will you stop?
When is Yankee Swap? They didn't email me.
I was going to do it after, before Christmas, maybe next week or the week
next
after.
Week, yeah.
Yeah,
you email me.
But I got to get a time where every, I want to do it at day or night where everybody can come.
By the way, the Realize coupons do expire, I
believe, very soon. Oh, shit. I don't have my backpack with me. I got to get use these Realize coupons.
They at the end of the show, at the they're done. Oh. So you can bring them in to the show.
I'm going
to
machine gun this motherfucker.
Oh, yes.
I am laying down.
I shouldn't have said anything.
You're not, you realize I have a combined 30 minutes of you being silent on that podcast. You're fucking done.
You get to use them.
I'm gonna,
at the end of the show, though, it's done. It's a wrap.
Okay.
So, okay. But
please, can we
until I give him 20 more Realize coupons.
Maybe we can force a special episode where I can draw. Let's just set up an episode. I can just drop them on them because I don't.
Well,
wanna...
we can set up the episode before. We can do like a 20-minute or a half hour.
That'd be fun.
Where you just drop it on them. Yeah. How's that? So Yankee Swap will be next week at some time. We'll work it out. Are you out of town?
I'm in town all next week, baby.
What about
I'm
you?
Wide open.
Yeah, I'm in town. I leave. Yeah, a week from Sunday.
What Monday would be best for me.
I mean, of course, you're in town.
I'm going out of town a lot coming up. I got some gigs.
Yeah, you just canceled the gig on me.
I'm sorry, dude.
No, dude, it's fine.
No, no, I would never.
You got a better gig.
Yeah, I needed the money, dude.
That's great.
I would rather just be in town and do the gig with you.
Right, right, right. No, that's great.
I'll take it.
Dude, yeah. my dream, I love when you guys fucking have to not work with me. No, because I love working with you.
We got a great one coming up.
That means you're going to be making some more money, so good
yeah.
for you.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got a sick gig.
You list and I.
2 weeks, right?
Oh,
yeah,
I'm
the 19th.
That.
What?
No, don't worry.
Oh, please, okay. Then you can step in and make his money.
I would love that.
No, I'm just kidding.
I just did that.
No, I'm kidding.
That's awesome, dude. The Paramount?
Oh,
what'd you do with it?
For the towel.
Yeah. So, yeah, we're doing that the 19th. Mm-hmm. Me, Dan, and Joe List. It's and a lot of people are coming.
That'd How are we awesome. Getting there? Because that day, I have an afternoon show at Caroline's.
Do you really?
At 3 o'clock.
Why don't you just take the train out?
I thought we were all going to
Oh, I have
together.
A ticket. Joe.
Oh, yeah, bro.
Merry Christmas, dude.
Yeah, dog. Thanks.
Wait, I got to put this in for Yankee Swap next week, so
you
might get the ticket. That's actually, I swear to God, that's what I should use for Yankee Swap.
They yeah, or you can just give ticket. Me a ticket so I can
They didn't
go
take my
free.
Ticket going to
what if
Huntington.
I did, what if I did a Mega Millions and it won for Yankee Swap?
How much would you fucking just put a knife in the neck of me if I got that ticket?
Yeah, I'd be happy. I'd be. You know what I'd be for? Your kid and your wife, that they wouldn't have to grow up fucking moving around so much.
Joe, that's for you, buddy.
Thanks, pal. I appreciate it. Valid through December 4th, 2014.
Right to Huntington.
Do you guys want to do any more fucking weird shit during the show?
What, giving each other stuff? I'm sorry, dude, that it's weird. Yeah,
this is
to be
fucking
giving.
Stoop shit you do when you're smoking a cigarette getting high.
I don't smoke cigarettes or get high. I appreciate the fucking train ticket, bro. That was really thoughtful.
Yeah, give
it's about
a
time
train
someone
ticket.
Does something thoughtful for me around here.
All right, I want to go to the latest chat, not your chats, the latest one.
The latest comment is Lauren Vagodis says, I just went back and listened to that episode where he gave the coupons. I was wondering when he was going to use those.
Yeah.
It made me miss Kelly.
And
I miss Kelly. You don't miss Kelly?
Yeah, totally.
I missed her one time with a baseball when I threw it at her head.
I liked it.
I added the effect.
It wasn't
so
terrible. Come on.
What else
guys.
You got?
Here's the thing. If you don't want to laugh, you're not going to laugh.
From yours.
Want to go ride bikes says, I wish Bobby would grow a beard. He looks like a huge baby.
If I grow a beard, I look worse.
Really?
Look yeah, that. I look like the fucking butler on Jesse.
What's Jesse?
What the hell show is Jesse? Yeah.
If you have a kid, you know.
By the way, Dan's fucking instinct is to be a phony and just laugh at anything
no, I
you
like
say.
Butler.
Oh my God, why would you say that?
Did you see that though?
When he said butler, I was like, this is going to be good. I was imagining him as fucking a Dom DeLuise looking motherfucker. It started making me chuckle. Then he said Jesse and I hit the brake. I don't know where he's going.
Do you really think Dan's a fucking piece of shit?
Not a piece of shit. A fucking corporate phony.
Really?
A phony.
You think
word.
I'm a phony?
You think Dan's a phony?
His head is phone-shaped, like the old phones.
That's a terrible joke to get out of this argument.
Not phony. I love you,
hey,
Dan.
You?
I was just stirring shit up.
You know
His
what?
Head is shaped like the first phone, because it's the
say,
size of my fucking apartment.
I would say I take your phony,
yeah.
and I switch it with positive.
Huh?
Yeah, I have a big head.
He said a bad joke.
You have a big head. You have dirty knuckles like a mechanic.
No, I don't.
I want to get to this with Lewis because this is a problem. this breaches beyond podcast. This goes to friendship.
Yeah,
what?
Ooh. If you think I'm phony.
Yeah.
You're not phony.
Ooh. Well, now you're being phony.
Yeah, you've called him phony a couple times today.
Today. Because I was laughing at the imagery he was putting in my head with him being a fat butler with a beard.
He never said anything about being fat.
Well, okay, well,
that's just what he is.
You know what? I didn't say fat. I just said butler.
Don't just turn this against me.
That's fucking you. What the fuck,
bigger,
man?
bum.
What?
Bigger I'm being realer.
Big bone butler.
More moderation. Yeah.
Boom. Big bone butler.
What, like a fucking dinosaur?
I said Dom DeLuise earlier and you didn't flip out about that.
Dom DeLuise is a genius.
All right. Well, a bearded Dom DeLuise type. It started making me laugh. He said Jesse and I bolted out. If I would have gone along with it and acted like I knew what Jesse was.
Then he would have been Kelly Vistuca.
That is true.
Yeah.
But I don't like this because you're my friend.
I'm sorry, Dan. I apologize.
And I know, and I wouldn't say phony. I'd say I have a positive. I thought it was going to go somewhere that I knew. So I started with the imagery, and then I pulled the brake.
I laugh at references I don't get all the time.
Thank you, Joe.
That's because you're a phony.
No, it's because you're a funny delivery. You're a funny guy. The way you tell your story, it's funny.
Funny like how? I amuse you funny?
That's the way you tell the story.
Like how, though? Like how? Like I'm a clown?
You know what I mean.
No, I don't know what you mean. What the fuck do you mean?
Oh, my God.
Like I'm a clown?
He has the same voice as Joe Pesci. Nobody's ever pointed this out before.
That'd be great if he was like,
by the way, speaking of Joe Pesci.
He takes off his suit.
Just unzippers his face. He's like,
That was good. We're back together.
We're back.
Me and Lewis are fine again. We just have to work through some stuff. A good relationship has communication. All
right, we're going
to
do a new part called The News. Scopo, go ahead.
The News.
We need music and we need a sound effect.
No, you need no music. You need to leave them out on that cliff.
You guys,
I don't even know what's in the news right now.
Do you know what's going on in the news?
Oh, yeah.
No, I'm talking to Dan.
Yes, I do.
Race
what's
wars.
Going on in the news?
I read the Daily Beast every day.
What is going on?
Currently...
Oh, I read the rape story in Rolling Stone. How about that news
story?
Well,
that got retracted.
Yeah.
I read it, and here's the thing. The journalist that wrote the story... didn't contact the people that accused the woman.
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, she was afraid of retaliation. And now this whole shitstorm is... Kurt Metzger had the best point. He always makes the best points on Facebook.
Why is Kurt Metzger...
He's fucking great at this.
Why is he so fucking amazing at his opinion and writing down and being funny and poignant at the same time? I read his shit, and I'm like, why is this guy not more famous or have his own show or... I mean, what the fuck is going on with Kurt Metzger? He is one of the fucking smartest, funniest guys out there.
And the shit that he puts on Facebook is always like, you're always like laughing, and then you're like, yeah, that's a good point. And sometimes you're like, that's clearly so, yeah.
I read his stuff sometimes, and I'm like, oh my God, this guy is fucking amazing. Like, why is he not more?
He's ugly.
Yeah.
Is that it?
And he pushes the envelope.
He does push the envelope.
He does. He looks like Bert and Ernie.
Yeah, dude. He's an ugly person. And he's not likable.
He's not that ugly.
He's not that ugly.
He's unlikable.
He's got kind eyes.
I think he's got great eyes. He's got nice lips. No. I mean, his nose is...
His nostrils are the size of a Coke can.
Dude.
They're huge.
Jesus Christ.
Dude, he
went from loving Kurt to shitting on
him. No, he's an ugly person. He's so funny.
Stop saying it.
He's one of my favorite comics in the world.
But he's not ugly.
But he's literally one of the ugliest human beings.
He's the best ugly comic there is.
100%.
I disagree.
That is a very true statement
That's a good one.
Best ugly comic.
I disagree. I think Kurt is not ugly.
I don't think he's ugly.
I think he's got great eyes.
The problem is you can see them from 500 miles away.
I think he's got good eyes.
He's got serial killer face, and he's tall, and he's scary. So that's why people aren't, like, giving him a TV show. But he will do. He'll be because he's like a comics comic. Every comic thinks he's the best.
And he's an Emmy-nominated award writer guy.
What?
Wow.
Something.
Joe just had a stroke.
Guys. Oh, God. His left side of his face
is dripping. What rape was he talking about?
No, he was talking about the Rolling Stone article that got retracted. And he just had
What was that?
A woman at the University of Virginia claimed that she was gang raped by a specific fraternity her freshman year. Turns out they did some investigation, and the journalist never contacted the accused, the person that she was accusing of raping her. And then they contacted the fraternity, and the fraternity provided information that made Rolling Stone want to retract that article, saying that they hadn't done their full investigation and that there was faulty information.
It was just terrible journalism.
Yeah,
because that's not what journalism is. You're not supposed to just tell a story from one person's perspective. And if you do, you should at least have like an asterisk being like, this is a completely one-sided story.
Well, the knee-jerk reaction to not victim blame was the issue, and you never want to. And there's this culture of like, well, if a woman says, before we talked about, you know, the YKWD show where I suck your dick, I was being kind of serious about that. If that was a woman, you can't point out the fact that, like, no, you were just kind of acting like an asshole that night. right, when it gets turned around on the guy.
I was an asshole?
No, no, me. As if I was a woman, it was me being an asshole. Woman or man, I was being an asshole that night. But if I was drinking and you're a guy in position of power and I was a woman and there was people cheering us on and I wanted to play it that way, you can never call me the asshole in that situation.
See, I think you're muddy in the waters right there, because I think a lot of victims, there's a lot more women that are sexually assaulted that don't come out than this story. This is always the fallback story. Anyways, this is getting away from the point. The point that Kurt made that I thought was hilarious was he made fun of all the Jezebels and the salons for being upset that an actual rape didn't happen.
Right.
Like, that was his opinion, which was fucking hilarious. He was like, you know, in his post, he's like, you guys are upset that a rape didn't happen? Like, this woman wasn't raped. That's a good thing.
Well, here's the thing, though. I think that she was, because she bumped into friends that night. In the article, she claimed that she was, shoved into a pitch-black room, which I said this when I first read the article. She's, like, into a pitch-black room, but then she identifies exactly how many guys are in the room, and then two of their... Who places. People are. So I'm like, well, how is it pitch black? Or do you know
eyes,
how people?
But your eyes adjust like a cat.
I guess so. So
very
then,
true. That's why pirates wear one patch, because when they have to go underneath, they take the patch off. That's true, actually. And then they can see underneath.
I like Lewis's Snapple facts.
All right.
Did you know pirates actually wear the patch not because they're missing an eye?
Yeah.
Fun fact after the break.
It's because they would keep one eye ready for the darkness at all times.
You fucking mate. It wasn't that they got it carved out by another pirate? Yeah.
And they have peg legs, so Lewis will believe them when somebody tells him a story about why they have peg legs.
That was a very. You just gave us just basically an outline of the joke you were gonna. You just didn't do it. You were like, and the joke is peg legs. Lewis believes peg legs.
Actually, you pitched a joke.
Yeah, guys, a joke along these lines. We might go into it some detail. I'm thinking the joke is another reference. That's the rudest thing you can do.
I'm sorry, my sister.
Sister, baby.
Beatrice is bringing the baby.
I know.
Right now.
Always
what do you want me to say?
I don't know. You just
that we get to hang out with a baby soon. That's pretty fun.
You're like this. I have to do a fucking difficult podcast while she just gets to drive around in New York City in the rain with a baby crying, and now I have to sit up here and have a fairly clever observation every fucking 30 minutes stoned with my friends, and it's really difficult.
Yeah.
Anyways,
I like the way Joe's dressed today. He looks like a meteorologist that's just about to give up, or a geologist. Damn it!
Wow, why'd you
create? Neither one of those made sense.
Geologist is funny because he's holding a pencil.
No,
I'm not dressed with a pencil. I'm holding a pencil.
I said you're holding a pencil.
Wow. You're like, I like the way he's dressed, holding a pencil.
He's trying to bail my buddy Lou out.
Let me just get undressed.
Are you and Lou's best friends?
No. He's one of my close friends.
I just thought.
Why would you quickly say it like that? You made me feel like you were my best friend for a minute.
I thought
you were one of my close friends.
He did say you are his best friend.
That's right. That's where I got that from.
Yeah.
I thought it was you. No, you can't.
Just like Rolling Stone, can I retract?
No, you can't. I actually, you said Dan was your best friend.
Nate Bargatze too.
Nate is your best friend too.
Actually, neither of them are my best friends. Dave Smith is my best friend.
Your hoodie strings are too long.
Me and Dave Smith have been friends before we did comedy. We were roommates before we ever did
comedy.
Just
answer the question, yes or no.
Listen, I know what...
Is he your best friend?
Yeah, he's my best friend.
So when you said Dan was your best friend,
one of my best friends.
You can only have one best friend.
That's why I corrected myself. There's one best friend, and that's why it's best friend.
Who's your best friend?
My best friend is Nate.
See, I disagree.
Nate Bargatze is your best friend.
Yes.
Nate's my son's godfather.
What's this one
best
friend?
That's not what I asked.
I'm Gary Veeder. Hold on. I'm Gary Veeder's best man. Do you know that?
Who's your best friend? Number one best friend.
I don't want to put this.
I could answer that question for you.
I have great friends.
Derek in Seattle.
Probably Derek, but then Canner. I'm very close with
Derek
Canner.
With Joe.
Why do you have Derek in Seattle? What are you, like Howard Stern? I'd like to call Derek in Seattle my best friend.
I don't think I've ever met a Derek that I've liked. Except for Derek Gaines.
Oh, you fucking followed up with another stinker, huh?
And you said that like I'm an asshole because I know a Derek I'm friends with.
Who's your best friend?
Lewis was hoping for such a reaction on that.
Who's your best friend, Scopo?
My buddy Phil.
Your buddy Phil?
We worked at Midas
buddy?
Together.
Your best friend is a buddy?
Buddy Phil.
Scopo, I'll meet you down at Sully's pub. God.
How can your buddy Phil be your best friend if we've never heard of this guy? Yeah,
he's the cop.
I talk about.
I didn't even know you were friends with a cop.
I didn't even hear you. I've never heard you talk.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
First of all, it's Scopo's fucking mentor. Scopo's going to be a cop in 3 years, guaranteed.
Who? Let's hope.
We know firefighter. So.
And you're going to be in jail, so. Yeah.
Who's your best friend, Deepu, besides a computer?
I honestly,
Siri?
Besides Star Wars. Yeah.
I honestly do not have a best friend right now.
But I am working on a program that will provide me with a best friend.
Can I apply?
Yeah, I mean.
Oh, Joe's Deepu combo.
All you need to do is bring a razor, and then he will let you into his life.
What the fuck, man?
He's got he's hairy.
He doesn't shave.
He's hairy.
Dude, he doesn't shave.
I got to find a chainsaw first.
Okay. All right, go back to switching the camera. I know, I'm kidding. Hey, that's the first time he's ever gotten the bandana.
Oh, wow, that's nice.
Yeah, can you put it over your head? Put it on that camera.
I can tie it like a turban if you like.
That would be pretty amazing.
Pretty funny.
We should get a bomb towel just for Deepu.
So that's great that you guys all have best friends.
Who's your best friend, Bobby?
Well, but here's the thing. I have a group of – also, I have a group of –
Hold on. I asked Bobby who his best friend is, Dan.
Sorry. Who's your best friend?
I'm not going to answer that.
Wow, why?
You're a fucking jerk off.
I'm kidding. I'll answer it.
Sarah Lee.
Who's your best friend?
I just wanted to say that. I'm not answering it, though.
Who's your best friend?
I would say it'd have to be Quinn.
I was going to say Jim Norton.
No.
I was going to say
I love Jim, but we don't talk that much. Okay. I talk to Quinn pretty much every day.
Okay.
And we talk and we have very full, interesting conversations, serious, out of it, laughing, observations, making fun of people, trashing each other, blah, blah, blah.
He trashes you behind your back, too.
Yeah, he doesn't like you. He actually said that you're one of his least favorite people.
Oh, I know that. Yeah, he's told me that. That's why he's honest. Yeah. That's why I appreciate it.
And I get it.
Because he actually says, I don't like you on the phone.
Why are you calling me?
Yeah, you guys are close because you have nicknames for each other. He calls you Chubby Nerd.
Right, Chubby Nerd.
Chubby Nerd?
You call him Quinn?
It's like a mean fifth grader?
Isn't that an Eddie Murphy movie?
Chubby Nerd.
I would say who's your second in command?
I mean, that's where it gets hard because then there's like my man like Dan
If you had gotten that text.
I pick your top three best friends.
If you had gotten my text.
Fucking, I can't do that.
I mean, literally, all three of these guys in this room are become my best friends.
I'm
talk with Scopo on the phone three, four times a week. We just talk on the phone.
All right, so where is Scopo with you? Where would you put him?
He's literally one of my best friends.
Scopo is.
Yeah.
Dan.
One of my best
friends.
I'm
right there.
Joe.
One of my best friends.
What about Deepu?
Who?
Deepu.
All right, so me, where am I in that?
You're one of my best friends.
What about... Okay.
No, actually, you're not one of my best friends. You literally said to me, I'm not your friend. Remember that conversation?
No,
I'll never forget because it hurt me. That was the one time. That was the one time I literally had to leave the room because Beatrice was watching me be hurt on my face.
I didn't say that.
You're not my fucking friend.
No.
You're my fucking friend. You're not Bill Burr.
No, because...
You're not Colin.
Because you were fucking, he was doing his, this is what he's great at taking shit, he's great at taking shit out of context. Do you think, Dan, you know me, you know me, I've known you the longest out of everybody in this
room.
That's
not true, I've known you longer than you've known Dan.
I've known him.
I literally have known you for almost fucking 10 years,
you've not known me. You've known of me.
I've known of you. We went on a boat, we played left, right, center on a boat.
That was a glance. Me and Dan have been friends.
Friends in my mind.
Me and Dan have been friends for how long, Dan? Long time.
Yeah, 6 years.
Okay, now Dan.
Dan,
I'm talking to Dan.
5 years.
Dan.
Yeah.
We've been. I mean,
I lived on your block 6 years ago.
Yeah, I saw you twice. Once without a shirt, getting arrested. You're a scary. You're not a friend.
I think I worked with you in 07.
But you did. Yeah, that's when I first met Bobby.
But I met him, and he was a fucking drunk on stage with a Guinness. Okay?
I was with him drunk,
Me and you have been friends since... I mean, we built... Since I met you, we kind of been consistent with a friendship.
What did you guys build? Right? You built a
couple decks?
About the deck?
You've been over my house.
Oh, wait, Lewis.
Blah, blah, blah. What? We've talked. We call each other just to say hi.
Just to say hello.
What's up? We have conversations.
Hi, click.
No. In all that time, do you really think that I would just be that ruthless, just out of the blue, just tell him, fuck you, you're not... Do you think there would be something, knowing him and then knowing me...
As the corporate in the room.
Do you think there's something behind that would fuel... That I would just say that to somebody.
No, I don't think it was an unprovoked reaction.
So you think there might have been something that would
I'm guessing
lit the fuse.
Heated argument goes to a point where you're angry and want to lash out and hurt Lewis.
Because he said some fucked up shit.
It didn't make sense.
He said some
fucked
up shit.
Do you remember what it was?
He tweeted a nutsack.
Go ahead.
Yeah. I was going to tell him, see if you remember. I said some fucked up
shit. What is it?
I tweeted my nutsack at you.
Right. So, I tweeted.
I tweeted it at Bobby, and then he lied to me and told me that Serpico saw it in front of his fucking 7-year-old kid.
No, because I was trying to hook this guy up with a bunch of shit.
Yeah.
Like, you know, TV, like trying to get him. And he's fucking out there being an idiot, like he usually is. Nutsack.
There's people
going to his Twitter to see who the fuck he is. And I'm like trying to have a conversation, dude. You gotta fucking. And he's like, dude, I'm just fucking doing what I do. And you know, I'm like, dude, listen, I don't even really know this fucking dude. Totally, I'm friends with you now. That's more so.
He had already gotten me management. We had been friends for two. I've been coming on the show for 2 years at this point.
But you can't tell me when I was friends with you. I know when I considered you a friend. And at that point, you weren't like in my inner circle.
You were a guy
that I was trying to help out, brother. You can't tell me. You think you bonded with me at some point.
We were friends 6 years ago with you.
We already did a Yankee swap.
No, we
didn't. Yeah, we did.
We weren't fucking.
Had you sucked
his
fake dick yet?
Brother.
Oh, that's a good one.
I was like 2 months away from sucking your fake dick. If we weren't friends at that point, that's fucked up, dude.
We became friends.
Then you got
dates. We became friends. Look, me and you are the same guy, basically. So our fuck yous back and forth happened more than me and Dan.
Was this?
Or me and Joe. I get that. So I'm not going to put it on you like you're just an idiot. I'm an idiot, too.
Do you remember why I sent my nutsack to you?
But here's the thing. I have no idea.
You banned me from the show.
I didn't ban you from the
show. You did. You and Paul fucking Verzi, Diet Luis J. Gomez. Yeah, dude, you're done.
Giannis was
you're
there.
Done.
Giannis
and
was
Giannis.
There.
You're done. I was like, I'm
Giannis,
done.
Giannis, Verzi,
and
same
then
thing.
I just, and then I just had a shot of my face thinking, but it was from the perspective of somebody who was looking from beyond my ballsack at me.
That wasn't the reason. No, it wasn't. It was because we got into an argument. I was like, dude, you got to stop. You fuck. It went back and forth, right? And I'm trying to explain to you, look, dude, this is about your career. There's people, blah, blah. And you're like, dude, I just did it. We were friends. I'm like, dude, fucking, you're not my best friend. We're not fucking pals. You don't come over. I don't call you when I have a problem. We weren't there yet.
I'm reliving it right now. It hurts again.
No,
the same
serious.
Way.
Hey, man, reality, fuck, I'm sorry. But we've become fucking friends. I've called him. He's called me, Dan, who I'm talking to. Going back and forth about shit. Me and you in the last maybe year have become better friends. We call each other. We work shit out. We've had our ups and downs, fights. I think that's how you become a friend. Me and Dan have never really had a fight ever.
I'm pretty vanilla.
Well, it's just who you are. I'm like him.
Say it again.
I didn't say it, dude. I think it was Deepu.
Say it again.
Deepu, did you call Dan phony?
But listen.
Yes, I did.
Listen, I consider you guys my friends. Not like Scopo just became my friends in the last year.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Oh, really? I thought you had to cross the threshold of funny to get
dude,
to your you, friendship.
Look, man, friendship is a fucking really meaningful thing. I don't just fucking give it to you. I mean, you gotta go through shit. To become friends with
an
somebody.
An obstacle course in his backyard. It was pretty mean. He made me do it.
His at-home ninja warrior course. Dude, you gotta use the hand
Dad,
bike.
Climb up the tree, Dad. You gotta climb up the tree with the spikes, how many guys can you be friends with? I mean, really, honestly. How many guys can you be seriously friends with?
I'm committed to a group of 6 in Colorado.
Right.
And then my comic friends.
Who are your comic friends?
I mean, I got a lot of... Lewis,
okay, yeah.
Jay,
yeah.
Nate,
right.
Vecchione, DeRosa.
Yeah, like, I'm not friends with... I mean, I like Vecchione a lot, but he's not my pal.
He's one of my best friends.
His roommate,
too. Yeah, but he doesn't call
it's
me... up. We don't talk, but I would talk
you're
to him
you're also in his will.
You understand the fucking difference?
Yeah,
like, Scopo doesn't call me up for advice. We don't talk every day, but I can sit... He's a friend, but he's not, like, my fucking best friend. I have, you know, Norton, Voss, Keith... Serpico, Tom Saletti, and Colin Quinn
are
my friends. and then it kind of goes off from
there.
But
the Gull?
But people, Gullman too. I love Gullman. Yeah, absolutely, Gullman's in there.
But Dane?
Dane's...
Dawn?
Well, my wife.
Yeah.
Max?
My wife's number one.
Max is tough to be friends with, though.
I have three people on my... I have three people on my favorites on my phone. Three people. That's
you're in my
three?
Favorites? That's I got 12.
You're my favorites.
I got a
that's
lot
fine.
Of, you know.
You're not in mine.
That's cool. You know.
Yeah.
I got a lot of people.
I have three people in my favorites. I used to have 30. What? And then I realized... This is stupid. I have three people that are my favorite people in the world.
Well, I have a lot of love in your life.
Huh?
Come on, bro.
What, you want to be my favorites?
I want to be in your favorites.
But you can't be, because I don't call you with all that. All
right, man.
The people that are in my
favorites. I'm not going to lie to you. You're not in my favorites.
Exactly. I'm not in your favorites.
Joe List is in my favorites.
Yeah, but I'm not in your inner circle.
Joe List is in my favorites.
No, but it's not that because...
No, your fucking inner circle is Dan.
I'm at a different level. You're a fucking old man. Who has done a TV show?
Man, that's just,
you can't. You're not
going to
come and smoke weed with us at the creek.
But I'll tell you this: if you did, it would be a lot of fun.
Listen, so awesome. I don't smoke
in
weed.
In fact, I would love you to come on Legion of Skanks. You've been the most requested guest for Legion of Skanks.
I've never been asked.
Come on, Legion of Skanks.
Yeah, but you say it like it's my fault. I've never been asked.
I don't think you would come.
But you've never asked.
Will
me.
You come on?
Yes.
100%.
Absolutely.
You are literally the most requested guest we've ever had.
I absolutely would come on. Why wouldn't
I? You're not weird with like people smoking weed around
you? Why would I reject you? I love Jay, I love Dave, I love you. I mean, not love, I like you a lot.
Yeah, so I'm not your friend, but you love me. You fucking priorities
like
are fucked.
No, but you are my friend. When I said that, I apologize for saying that.
I know.
I really do.
It's kind of,
I didn't mean it.
Why are you gonna bring it up again?
It was more of a point, like, listen, dude, I'm trying to help you as a person and in this business. I'm not, stop putting it on the friendship, like, I'm just pals. We're buddies, man. I was kidding. Fuck that. Listen, I'm trying to help you with something to get, for you and your career and your family, and I'm trying to tell you something right now. You're not listening. You're making it about busting balls and being a buddy. Fuck, I should have phrased it better. Of course you're my friend, dude. You've been to my house. I don't invite people to my house. I don't like. If you don't come to my house... I'm not gonna. If you come to my house, I love you. That means you're definitely part of my circle.
And then once
and you're invited to everything I do.
And once you place
I shouldn't have said that.
Obstacle course.
I apologize.
Then you can come in the house, Lewis.
Do you accept my apology?
No. Grovel.
Okay.
You're a.
I'm really sorry. No. So there you go.
Well, thanks, bud.
I love all you guys, man. Nothing made me happier when you canceled the show the other day. I was like, good, your headline is somewhere. That's fucking great.
Oh, I felt bad. I didn't want to.
No, feel great.
Good.
I want you to, that means that you are making more money somewhere else.
Yeah.
And it's your gig.
Not a ton more.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter. It's your gig and you have, that's your objective. That was my objective, to work with this guy and have to say, I don't work for you anymore because I'm doing my own thing.
Bobby Kelly, get money.
Son. Dan used to come with me all the time. Now he's fucking doing the same clubs I'm doing for more money.
No, that's not true. I'm good doing for quarter audiences.
I know. No, I'm kidding.
You're always the one that accurately calls. Like when I'm on the road, I call Nate when I want to bitch about something because Nate's just great at just hating shit with you.
Is he?
He'd be like, oh, that's terrible. Right. I hate it. It sucks.
Right. Uh-huh.
And then you're the one when I need like the pep talk. You're like, dude, I've called you in so many Target parking lots walking to my hotel room. Just you being like, dude, this is what you wanted. You wanted to be a headliner. You're not going to have tickets sold. And it's just like, yeah. And then I call Liz when I want a good laugh. And I call Lewis if I need some dietary advice.
What do you call Scopo for?
Nothing.
No, he doesn't really call me.
But I like Scopo. My face lights up when he texts me.
Really?
You know who's really hot, dude?
Who?
What?
That chick on your show. Oh.
Which one?
Yeah.
Liz? Oh, God. She's
which
so
one?
Nice. I literally Liz. I could jerk off to her Instagram.
The comedian?
No.
The one from last week?
The girl who's on your show. The TV show.
Oh, the TV.
No, Liz. Gillius.
Oh, yeah, she's...
Smoking. Oh, dude, I was... Dude,
she's around my age, right?
She was supposed to come in. You wanted to come in?
Up. Dude, please have her come in.
I'm going to have her come in and not have you on the show.
He's definitely not on the show.
If you don't have me on that show, I will literally... I take back accepting your apology. You are not my friend. Yeah, I can.
But you literally cannot take it back.
But
you
can.
I literally
don't like... This is what I don't like. This is what a psycho I am. I don't like that he took the apology... Like I owed it to him, but he had nothing to apologize to. You know what I mean? Like he was just, absolutely 100% right in that conversation.
In the corporate world, we call this admission of fault.
When you think back, it was kind of funny, the picture of my balls.
Dude, it...
That's your put on the rubber glove in the fucking in the OJ case. That's the leather glove defense.
And that was back when we were doing, when I was kicking you off the show and just, we were making you do the five fucking
things. Yeah, the acts of kindness.
Yeah, the acts of kindness and kicking you off. Dude, that was not real. I mean, I kicked you off the show like a couple months ago for real.
Yeah. Wait, what?
No, I'm kidding. Yeah, Liz is very pretty, man. She's, and here's the deal, okay? We're shooting a scene, I think. It's this week.
Mm. I'm shooting something, too.
And that's why I won't have her on the show. She...
Because of his uncle humor?
No. They're supposed to do this whole dance scene where they put her into literally nothing. It's straps going across her body.
Okay.
And I knocked on her door, and they were like, "We're busy doing a fitting." And I went, "It's me." And she goes, "Oh, yeah, open it up." She's so fucking badass and funny. She goes, "Open it up. Come on in." I opened the door, dude. I felt my knees. I fell to the ground.
Yeah.
Dude. Oh, my Lord. Literally just leather straps going across the breasts and the GG. And she's just, and her
how
hair
bad did
was...
You, how bad did you want to be 93 Bobby at that moment?
Dude, I wanted to be sexy Bobby so bad.
You wanted to morph into sexy Bobby.
Yeah.
Licking your lips like LL Cool J.
I just wanted to go, "What are you doing tonight? You want to hang?" "I got a show down the cellar at 12. I'm doing the last spot." She's so hot. She's so funny, too, though. She's fucking hilarious.
She's not funny, dude. She's just that hot.
Dude, she's funny.
That's the power of hot chicks.
I'm telling you, dude.
They can convince you that they're smart and funny. Dude, she's a genius, and she's hilarious,
I didn't say
dude.
She's genius, dude. She is fucking funny, dude. Mm. She does shit. Like, she'll be, like, sexy with her, you know, their titties out, whatever. And one of the other guys will look and be like, she'll be like, "What are you doing? Oh, my God, I feel uncomfortable." Mm-hmm. And she'll just start acting like she's been, like, assaulted. And other people will look around, and then she starts laughing. It's like, "You fucking psycho."
Yeah.
She goes, like, she's with her boyfriend. She'll, in the mall, she'll just fall. She'll just fall like he pushed her. "Oh, my, I'm sorry." She'll just say, "I'm sorry."
No offense, Bobby. This sounds terrifying. She's like, "Why would you do that? Why would you push me down the stairs?"
Were her ex-boyfriends to spend time in prison because she lied about them?
She's dating. I had a pretty good life.
Her boyfriend's 41, too.
How old is she?
She's 21, I think. 21.
Yeah.
That's not going to work out.
Yeah, she's amazing. It's amazing. She's so funny.
One of the hottest girls. I mean,
Wait, I want to
She tweeted at Ariana Grande. I was on her Twitter.
They're best friends.
Oh. I mean, dude, I would literally...
She should come on the show.
I would never
from Jersey.
See James again for one night with Ariana Grande.
Really? I followed her on Twitter, and it just bugged me.
Well, hopefully we can get her in here, because that would be the best thing that ever happened to James.
Why would you fucking even say that?
I'm just kidding.
Oh.
Wait, what's this? Hey, type in the actress's name.
I'm kidding. They're all jokes, dude. Never being serious.
Type in the actress's name so I can follow her.
Ever.
Not even about the fucking...
Like an old man.
I didn't even move.
Yeah, his life... He actually is... he's not even Puerto Rican. Okay.
Nice talking to you.
All right,
guys.
Liz Gillis?
Did you find it?
Yeah.
How do I spell the last name?
I don't know.
G-I-L-L-I-E-S, something like that?
Somebody's a fucking student.
All right,
we're going to wrap this up, guys. This is getting boring. You guys have been amazing. Let's go. Let's wrap it up. Lewis, what do you got?
Guys, come check me out at the end of January. Go to gomezcomedy.com, and I'm going to be headlining in Toronto, Comedy Bar, and the Underground, the Weed Bar.
Fucking love there. The Weed Bar, she is amazing.
She's the best, dude.
She's one of the nicest people in the world. And the place fills up.
Yeah, every time.
Yeah, I got to actually cut my set short because I get fucked up.
Yeah.
I got to really just go run outside, but unbelievable place.
Such a fun time.
And the Comedy Bar is awesome, too, man.
Yeah, really. So go check that out, guys. Yeah. Got some shows. And then I guess that's later on. I got some shit coming up. I'm with Bobby Kelly, January 31st, Mohegan Sun. Which
one did you cancel? Bananas?
I canceled Bananas for Toronto.
That's a good one. You did that with me before.
Yeah, it's great.
It's a great gig. Okay, cool.
Yeah, and so go to my Twitter at Lewis J. Gomez, and check out my other podcasts, Real Ass Podcast, Hammer Fisting,
all
and
seven
Legion
of them.
Skanks. I got three other podcasts. What?
What?
What, bro?
What?
What?
What? The Real Ass Dude. How's that going?
Real Ass Podcast. Scopo kicking ass on it. Yeah, way more, better on the Real Ass Podcast than this.
Yeah, because he's more relaxed.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
When are you going to loosen up on this show?
I don't know. Your tone.
My tone?
Yeah, I'm scared of you.
What the fuck are you talking about? All right, Dan.
Hi.
What do you got?
I'm going to be in...
I hate when you guys get stoned.
Providence, Rhode Island. Stoned.
You're doing fucking either Coke or coffee.
I brought so much more energy in the second part of this.
Oh. Are you taking your dick out?
I shit my pants.
Yeah, you absolutely did.
I think I just shit.
There was no audio.
I think I just shit. Oh, my God.
I'm going to be in D.C., Providence, Rhode Island, Los Angeles. Merry Christmas.
All right, next week, Yankee Swap. What about our fucking show?
19th.
Plug it.
Long Island.
Plug it.
What theater?
Paramount.
Paramount Theater.
You don't care if it's not yours, huh?
Oh, bullshit.
Then say something.
It's the then Paramount. Say it. It's Joe, Bobby, and I.
Say it.
Quit bullying me, Bobby.
Say it.
Paramount Theater, December 19th. Tickets on sale now, robertkellylive.com.
Why'd you go down? Go up.
No, I don't know what you're saying. Go up. I'm confused.
All right, good. Joe, what do you got?
I have Listomania t-shirts for sale, I think. I don't even know what's shaking over there. I get people going, hey,
really?
they're sold out.
What about this? We have it up on the screen coming, right?
Yeah, everybody,
I made an ad for
everybody's
it.
Going, we need more, we need more, we need XLs, we
right
need
there. It's in the video. Look at the video. He put it in the video. Get your Listomania t-shirts right now at riotcast.merchtable.com.
For God's sakes, my kids are fucking starving at
home.
You
don't have kids, you fucking nut.
What if I do someday? They'll be hungry. January 8th, 9th, and 10th, I'll be at the Tacoma Comedy Club in Tacoma,
Washington. Why are you fucking stepping over the show we have coming up?
He promoted it. You promoted it.
You promote it.
What the fuck are you talking about, you egghead? He just promoted it. You're about to promote it.
See what he's doing?
All three of us got to promote it? You fucking jerk off.
What's the order of that show?
January 23rd and 24th, Dead Crow Comedy Club, Wilmington, North Carolina. That's January 8th through the 10th.
That sounds fun.
And Tacoma. And January 23rd to the 24th, Dead Crow, Wilmington, Dogs. Come on up, bro.
Jesus Christ.
The Rotting Carcass Comedy Show.
I actually heard it's a great club.
The Edgar Allan Poe Comedy Room.
You guys are fucking idiots.
I actually think it sounds like a great club.
Yeah, you're fucking right, Dan. I'll put in a good word for you.
Hey, Dan, go fuck your fucking political fucking neutral face.
No one said I'm ever political and neutral. I'm business neutral, baby.
Ugh, God. Two packages delivered. UPS movies. Fuck, it's not my package.
What movies you get?
What package, bro?
Why don't I have my SAG screeners yet? I joined the fucking SAG. Where's my fucking
you're
DVDs?
You're not nominated.
That doesn't make
be
sense.
Nominated.
Yeah,
you
fuck
have to
off.
Be nominated.
No, you don't.
All right, I'll tell you how to do it. You ready? You want to know how to do it?
Yeah.
You have to vote. So if you don't vote.
Vote for what? The president?
Vote for Screen Actors Guild awards. You vote for those.
Okay.
And you vote, if you vote for those and pick all, I sit there and pick them out every year, me and Don. That one's going to win, that one's going to win. And then they send them to you because you actually vote.
How do I vote? I'll go vote.
They send you a fucking thing.
I'm voting for Jill Stein.
Right, you bringing him up here?
Yeah, bring him up for a minute.
Okay.
Yeah, baby!
Baby!
I love the baby so much more than any other baby.
God, you can bring her up, too,
you
right?
You know what I mean?
Okay. I'm a bigger fan.
Go ahead.
Everybody.
Go.
I'm done, you fucking knucklehead. Dead Crow and you shit all over it. You made me look like a fucking idiot.
I love Dead Crow, man. It's the best comedy club in fucking Illinois.
Wilmington.
North Carolina.
North Cackalacka.
Yeah.
Be there.
What do you got for me?
For you? December 19th, the Paramount.
Oh, I didn't hear about that fucking 1 minute ago, you chooch.
December 31st, Comedy Connection in Rhode Island.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
It's New Year's Eve, dude.
Wow. Look at you, East Providence, under the highway in a fucking old bank. fucking jerk.
Fucking great room.
It is a great room, and I'm headlining there, too, coming up.
Me, too. All three of us are there.
I'm there New Year's.
Yeah.
Oh, special event.
Oh, that's interesting. I'm at Caroline's on Broadway.
Me, too, bro. We're bringing it in.
Is that right?
Three. Yeah.
Fuck my mother. I'm so happy.
It's me, you, Norman, Michelle Wolf.
And Ricky Velez and Gary Veeder.
And Gary Veeder. Wow.
Wow, that's a
sit on a dick.
Fucking mediocre show. Go ahead.
I appreciate that, Bobby.
January 23rd, 24th, Bananas in Hasbrook Heights.
You don't like bananas?
I love bananas.
You want
the food?
Do you want to take his middle spot? Do the middle spot with me?
No, I'll be at Dead Crow Comedy Club that weekend in Wilmington.
Arr.
Which sounds better, folks? Write in. Dead Crow or Bananas?
They both sound like shit. That sounds like what Dead Crow eat.
Mm-hmm.
What? Oh, what? Shit.
Dead Crows don't eat.
Bananas.
Dead Crow don't eat.
That doesn't sound anything like what a
Dead
Crow would
eat. I think
Dead
Crow sounds cool. I know a couple of people have been there. They said it was a great club.
Yeah,
this
it's
actress
great.
Is beautiful.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Why are you winking?
I'm not winking. I'm on camera, dude. Don't stop lying. Go ahead. Let's get this over
with.
Are
we done? I don't know. You guys go back and forth.
What else do I have?
And then March 6th and 7th, Arlington Draft House.
I love that club.
Yeah, that's great.
All right. So anyways, thank you everybody who...
voted.
They didn't vote. They actually donated. Went out and bought gifts for kids. You guys are amazing. It really helped out. I really appreciate it. Make sure you go and check out all these guys at their clubs. See them locally because that's what we do for realsies is stand-up comedy. So support us and go up to us after the show and let us know that you heard about the show from the YKWD podcast. Is that Deepu, you got anything?
No, I got nothing. Just follow me on Twitter at R2Deepu.
What about you?
Just follow me on the Twitter.
That's all you got?
Yeah, I mean, I got shows in the city, but I'm not going to promote them.
Okay, good for you. Yeah. That's a way to work
I'll
it.
I'll be at LOL.
All right. And let's end uncomfortable.